time for Friday Night Lights. It's time for some football, coach. Woo! My name is Dave Rimbold. I am your play-by-play announcer tonight. With me, as always, is the coach, Chad Graham. How we doing, Chad?
Man, we couldn't ask for a better night for football to start our season.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun game. The first game of the season is always really interesting, Chad, because I don't think you think you know what you have, but you don't know until you see it out on the field.
How it all comes
together. And even such, though, like, you know, technology is miles ahead where it was, like, back when we were in high school. But even then, the coaches don't know what the opposing team, like, often is really going to have. So you're just doing a bunch of guesswork. You're looking at heights and weights and what they did last year, the returning players. And it kind of makes for this kind of, like, excitement for the first game of the year where it's just, you just don't know what you're going to get. Now, what I think we're going to get is a pretty good Chanute High School team.
During warm-ups, they definitely look dominating in all three aspects, the line, the defensive backs, and then the linebackers. I mean, then we look at the offensive side. You've got speed. You've got the offensive line. A lot of returners coming back. Didn't lose very many offensive linemen.
Yeah. Yeah, it should be interesting. We lost some skill position players, as you mentioned, but the lines, the beef up front and on the defensive and offensive line is going to be formidable. I think everyone expects that Chanute High School's lines are going to be the strength of the team. And so we'll see what happens. There's a lot of excitement, though, with some of the younger players on the skill position spots. You got Quentin Harding, who got time last year, got some rushes, and ran the ball well. He got time, middle linebacker, looked good on that side of the ball on defense. And, of course, you've got wide receivers who, you know, wide receiver, we were pretty set last year with Dagan Dean and some of those guys that have now gone on. Caden Seamster, who you see on the graphic on the screen right now, is one of those returning players. And they kind of expect him to take a step up. He's the guy now.
He definitely had a great season last year playing both sides of the ball, playing free safety, Roman. But 731 yards of when we had so many to pick from.
Yeah, of course, we talked about Quentin Harding. He's going to be an exciting player. I think one that a lot of people think on both sides of the ball is going to do some great things. And so we're excited to see him get his shot, you know. But last year he's behind Ty Leedy, who's just a once-in-a-decade kind of player. And so now Quentin gets his chance to show what kind of player he's going to be. And that's kind of exciting.
And he was running people over just like Ty last year. So he shouldn't be any change in the filling of those shoes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So we're getting there, and we got some additional players for you to watch. Of course, it all starts with the beef on the line, Augustus Thuston, an all-state player last year. He is a guy that's huge. He can move, and he's powerful. Hunter Anderson, also on that line. We talked about the line being a strength. He is a tackle as well. Jace Tarter, number four, the cornerback on defense. He got a lot of playing time last year and had some stats.
He was an outstanding corner last year. Seen him lining up there again this year.
You got Jordan Duncan, who I hear exciting things about, out at wide receiver. And then Cash Fitzmorris, who has the best name on the entire football team.
He got in quite a bit in the second parts of this season last year at linebacker. We got to see some of his hits.
Yeah, so really, yeah, everyone out there, everyone on that list had time last year. And so you're going to be able to see them step up tonight. And we'll see what kind of team we have. This is going to be the first looks, really, for us. The coaches know. They've been seeing them in practices. But then, you know, sometimes, coach, how it is. I wasn't a practice player. I never looked good in practice. But when the game came, that's when you look good. Some players are like that. They need the game to get the adrenaline going. The adrenaline's half their game. And
they let go of some of the stuff and just bring it.
So even then, the coaches may not be sure exactly what they're going to get out of these kids. But we're sure of something, that this is going to be a fun night. Football season's here officially, and it's going to be fun to watch just how good Chanute High School can be. Of course, last year they were very good, 9-1.
Took that disappointing loss.
Yeah, I mean, it was disappointing, but at the same time, Piper's a really good team, and they just happened to match up with them in the first week. It's a great game, but it's a new season. It's a new dawn here. new things to prove, new schedule, and we're about to embark on it together. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back. You're watching Comet Vision.
June Reneke. Knox Reneke.
The Fire Escape Coffee House is dedicated to high school and college students. Our mission is for every student in Southeast Kansas to know they have value, they are loved, and that they have a place. We are not a church, but we are motivated by the love God has for all of us. The Fire Escape opened in 1998 and is open every Friday and Saturday night for high school and college age students. During the week, the Fire Escape is open to the public Tuesday through Friday mornings for coffee, catch-ups, or small groups like Bible studies. The Fire Escape Coffee House is proud to partner with the Chanute High School Tech classes on this broadcast.
Cut. Beautiful. Okay, let's go again.
Tell me about your vision.
At the end of the day, it's your classic coming-of-age story.
Can I need more shipping labels?
All the gig speed, fiber-fueled internet you need to take whatever and make it big. Sparklight Internet, a stronger connection.
KFEX 93.1 FM and Comet Vision are excited to partner with Dr. Grant Gastineau. Dr. Gastineau graduated from Chanute High School and is committed to supporting the activities of the youth of Chanute. Thank you, Dr. Gastineau. We appreciate your support. Cardinal Drugstore, located at 103 East Main in downtown Chanute, is a small-town pharmacy and gift store which includes an old-fashioned soda fountain. They specialize in compounds and vaccines. They also supply many types of medical items. Cardinal Drugstore is your one-stop shop for all of your healthcare needs. KFEX and Comet Vision are so grateful for your support. From kickoff to the final lap, from peewees to the weekend pros, our team of doctors can help with the diagnosis and treatment of sports-related injuries. Wherever you are in your sports journey, Labette Health Sports Medicine Team has the training, experience, and skill to repair, restore, and renew. For more information about Southeast Kansas' leading orthopedic and sports medicine program, go to labettehealth.com.
The Medicine Shop Pharmacy, located right across the street from Royster Middle School in downtown Chanute, is in the business of making you feel better, faster. With three licensed pharmacists, the Medicine Shop has the knowledge to know the right drugs and the proper dosage to ensure your safety. If you're not quite up to your game, Medicine Shop offers delivery to your door. The Medicine Shop, a proud underwriter of the Chanute Blue Comets.
Thank you.
Robert Sprout. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like for you to direct your attention to midfield for the praying of our Chanute High School alma mater by the Chanute Blue Pride Marching Band. And now, ladies and gentlemen, won't you please rise for the presentation of the colors by the American Legion Post 170 Honor Guard. Now, in honor of the United States of America, under the direction of Dr. A.J. Bew, the Chanute High School Blue Pride Marching Band, with our national anthem. Thank you. Now, Director Dickon, your Shades Blue Comets, and let's take the treat together.
All right, you have been enjoying the sights and the sounds of Friday night high school football, the return of Friday night high school football, first game of the season. The fireworks have been lit, the hot dogs are being eaten, the kids, the little kids are all playing their own games of football in the corners, but now it's time for the real thing. It's time for the main event. Coach Chad Graham with us. Let me ask you a question. Are you the kind of coach, first game of the year, where you come out and say, I'm going to go a little vanilla, we're going to get our feet under us, or do you just start dropping bombs? What do you do?
Well, it all depends on what your last 2 weeks have went like.
Okay. And context.
If their line stayed together and then we filled in those key positions, I don't see why he wouldn't just come out with the pedal down.
Yeah. Yeah, so you expect... It's an interesting combination because they've got some experience on the lines, but you got some new kids in the skill positions. So it's an interesting juxtaposition and it'll be interesting to see. And I think Coach Cleet Frizzell has proven himself to be a guy. Let it all hang out. Let's go out and throw the ball around and we'll see. It'll be interesting to see what we see here in the first couple drives.
We're probably going to see more run than we do pass, starting with the sophomore quarterback, but you never know.
Yeah. We are about go for game time. The coin flip has happened, and the teams are getting ready. They're getting limber. They're getting themselves into a frenzy. And we're gonna get this season underway, and all the questions are going to get answered really quick. We will get the starters to you, like, kind of as they come out. We're not privy to a lot of information at the beginning of a high school season. This isn't the ESPN. They're not giving us scouting reports. We don't know much about Augusta. We'll try and fill you in as we go along, get the names as close as we can to right. Of course, you can always leave a comment on the old live stream there if we're getting a name wrong. We will take a look at that sometimes, and we'll try and work with you. But mostly we want to say good luck to all the kids out there. We're praying for no injuries.
Right. Have a safe game and bring it.
Let's just have a fun game. As the teams take the field, Chanute High School will receive and get the first offensive possession of the game. Caden Seamster.
And Stevenson back in deep.
Quentin Harding. They will be the two back men to receive this ball. The kicker for Augusta is a large young man, Jeremiah Schaefer, a senior kicker who can beat me up. Here it comes. The kick is in the air. It's high and long. Taken at the 9 by Seamster. He's got a big block on the left side. Makes the man miss. Got a hole up the middle. Dancing his way across the 26-yard line. That's where the Blue Comets will take over.
Well, special teams did a good job there doing their cross line. They crossed each other's face. Someone just got off their block. Or that might have went all the way.
So first down and 10. They mark it at the 25. We'll get our first look at the Blue Comet offense. Under the lead of sophomore quarterback Chris Harding II. So we're going to get our first real look at this young man. You've got Jace Tarter out wide. You've got Cade Small out there. No, excuse me. That is Owen Luttrell. The handoff goes to Harding. He is working his way up the middle and then gets thrown down after about 2-yard gain.
His wheels never stop turning, but just not much there.
So second down and 8 here on the Blue Comets first drive. Big 76 in there for Augusta. Cooper Jay, another senior. A lot of seniors on that Augusta line.
A pretty good size line.
Trips to the far side. Harding in the shotgun. He looks, throws it out wide. A little screen to the wide receiver, caught by Jace Tarter. Gain of a few.
Looks like 5.
Nice, easy pass. Get Harding. A little confidence.
He didn't. It was just a 3-step drop. He didn't have to. He just waited for his guy to come around. And
it's going to be about 3rd down and 3, so a 3rd down opportunity here on the first drive for the Blue Comets. We'll see what Coach Frizzell dials up here. Wide receivers on both sides now. Harding in the shotgun, or excuse me. Yes, Harding. Pass is incomplete.
Just a little bit down.
So quarterback Chris Harding II, running back Quentin Harding. They're not related, are they? Or are they related? No, they just have the same last name. That's not going to be confusing at all. 4th down. Henceforth, we will refer to them as Chris and Quentin.
All right.
4th down and 3 in the Chanute Blue Comets. We'll bring out the punting unit for the first time this season. So 3 and out on the first drive of the year.
See if Augusta sends their whole team to get a block here.
Having Seamster back to punt is a nice little weapon to have. He's got a good punt away. It's high and it's angled to the side of the field. Takes a snoop bounce and out of bounds.
Oh, it went through his hands even.
Had good hang time regardless. He wasn't going to get much of a return out of that.
I agree. It was a good kick.
So now Augusta looking to create a little on the road momentum. We'll see what they can do on their first offensive possession, and we'll get a good look at this Chanute line that we've heard a lot about going into the season. Up front, Canton Fitzmorris, like 59, Garrett Love at your tackles. Augusta quarterback, he's a big boy. Hands it off to the right, and after a gain of about 2, he's wrestled down. As the Blue Comet line stands strong.
In there by Luke Austin, 59, Garrett, you got number 46.
Gain on that tag. We gained him about 3. That's going to bring the Orioles
out to
their own 32.
Rather, that's cash.
Gavin Kaiser, the quarterback for Augusta. He's a senior. So seniors in a lot of places.
They'll be playing outside linebacker.
Here's Kaiser back to pass. He's looking. Now he's being forced, and he's going to go down. Big quarterback sack.
Smalls on that sack.
Small ran up the middle.
And boy,
he ripped through that line. Quarterback Kaiser had no time.
Took place where Dean left, smashing the quarterback.
Looks like it's a
Small started last year at DN.
Third down and 18. Long way to go here on Augusta's first drive. As this Chanute defense will drop back here. Elliot Stevenson, sophomore safety, directing traffic. Kaiser's got the snap. Here comes the Blue Comets. He's flushed out of the pocket. He's got some room to the right. He throws. He might have been past the line of scrimmage.
He has to have been past the line of scrimmage.
It was really close. The pass was caught, and I don't see.
They didn't call it.
I don't see a flag.
Kaiser out of the scramble.
It was very close to being past the line of scrimmage. Chanute players looking around. Take a look at it on the instant replay. Oh, it was hard to see. At any rate, it's a first down for Augusta. Nice throw and catch. Nice movement by Kaiser. We'll assume the officials got it right. Here's the snap and the handoff to the running back. The right side, he's got a hole till he takes a big hit. But a good gain on first down for Augusta.
Sumter came up and gave a smack to him.
Gain of 8. So Augusta, a little early momentum.
Orioles into Blue Comet territory.
Our front four are just going to have to shut down those lanes. They're cutting it back on us.
Little pistol formation for the Orioles. Two receivers to the near side on second and short. Here's the turn, the give to the running back.
He's
got a first down, plowing his way on the right side. The running back, Caden Stillwell, another senior for Augusta. First down and 10. So Chanute defense getting an early test here. Back on their heels a little bit.
Nice to see D-line subbing in and out for keeping them fresh for the guys that are going both ways.
Kaiser in the gun. He waits for the snap. He's got it. He turns, hands the ball off. Now the Blue Comets are there.
He tries to go outside, and there was nothing.
Stillwell didn't have much room. Blue Comet defense was swarming, and it's a gain of about 1.5.
Slight gain on the play. Led in there by Blue Comets. Number 44, that's going to be Landon Bilby at number 52.
Landon Bilby in on the tackle.
Gain of a half on the play.
Landon, a junior, 6 foot, 190-pound linebacker. Second down, and we'll call it 9. Kaiser gives to the wide receiver, and he's going nowhere.
Perfect.
Number 44,
Landon Bilby.
Bilby, second play in a row. He's in on the tackle. We read it the whole way, Coach.
Yeah, he was outside. Receiver didn't leave, and he just knew what was coming.
Brady Alonzo, sophomore, runs onto the field. Sophomore, 6'3", 238 pounds on the line.
Just a lot of youth.
That's a lot of beef.
Yep.
Chanute's got a lot of beef on the line. They're like Arby's, except you don't have to pull up to the trash can to wait for it. Third down and 9. No, make that 12. Here's Kaiser, fakes the handoff. He's back to pass. He's looking, flushed, looking. Ball tipped, incomplete.
Good pressure by just the front three. That was a good defensive change.
Garrett Love pressuring the quarterback there. May have gotten a piece of it. And it's going to be fourth down and 12. They are past midfield. We'll see if they go for it. No, they're shuttling on some players. So this looks like it might be a punt. Augusta, maybe playing it safe. Might be the right call on the road. First game of the year.
I'd like, pin them back deep while you can. You shut them down their first time.
They're still running on some players as Curtis Smith runs on, senior D-back. A punter for the Orioles stands on his own 38. The snap gets to him. No rush. It's a line drive kick. It's going to take a weird little sideways hop, and that'll be enough to make the Chanute player not try to field it. And it gets down at the 9-yard line. So Chanute back in their own territory. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back. You're watching Chanute High School Football on Comet Vision.
Is unveiling unlimited internet for just $25 a month. Get reliable 100 meg internet for just $25 a month for 12 months with unlimited data. That's unlimited internet. Call 877-469-3057 or visit sparklight.com/savings. Sparklight, a new breed and high speed.
Home Savings Bank is a platinum underwriter here at the Fire Escape Coffee House. Home Savings Bank has been serving the Chanute area since 1886. Customer owned and customer driven, Home Savings Bank, located at 214 North Lincoln Avenue in Chanute, Kansas, is here to serve all your banking needs. Whether your needs are checking, savings account, safety deposit box, lending, or online banking, Home Savings Bank is here to help. Home Savings Bank is located on the internet at homesavingschanute.com. Home Savings Bank is committed to the youth of Southeast Kansas and helping the ministries at the Fire Escape Coffee House.
False. Well, we had an illegal procedure with a late call. We didn't realize it until too late. But they're going to make him re-kick it, Coach.
That's nice. Nice call. Hopefully we'll get a strong return on this one instead of getting pinned back at the 9-yard line.
So Jeremiah Schaefer, the punter for Augusta. You know, it didn't look pretty, but it was actually a pretty effective punt. Probably why they're taking the penalty here.
Had enough hang time.
So we'll see what kind of kick he gets away here. Here's the snap. Schaefer puts it in the air. This one's a lot higher, a lot better, and it's not going to be fielded, but
takes a better bounce.
The penalty works out for Chanute, and instead of on the 9, they gain about 10 yards on the penalty and will take it at their own 19.
Goes to the out of bounds.
Well, Coach, we'll see if Chanute's offense is a little more settled down, a little more ready on their second possession here. Augusta's defense was up to the task on the first possession, and I think if we're being fair, that little question I asked you at the beginning was there with a little vanilla play calling. It was just a run, a quick wide receiver screen. We'll see if they let Chris Harding throw this ball down the field a little bit on this drive.
Open it up and try to open up the run a little bit. Be interesting to see who's starting to wear down with the heat.
Yeah, yeah.
Who got in better shape?
First game of the season usually features a lot of cramping, a lot of cramping up in the heat.
Yeah.
Well, so we'll see if that affects the game as we go on. It's fun to watch the complete student experience here. You got the cheerleaders doing their thing. You had the band before the game. You'll see the band at halftime. Like to point out, it's not just the football players. A lot of kids that are putting in a lot of work that leads to this moment, this event.
Just like what we're getting, the screen we're on right now. Dave, yeah. There's a great team beside us that are putting this on.
Yeah, absolute shout out to Comet Vision, the TV, the television broadcasting class. What you're not seeing is the crew in the box here with us, led by teacher Caleb Wood, who instructs the class. But there are about 12 kids in here who make it all happen, doing the production work. They got the screens. They're hitting the buttons. And they are the ones behind this professional-looking stream you're watching. First and 10 for Chanute. The Harding and Harding Law Firm in the backfield. Chris Harding awaits the snap. He's got it, gives the handoff to Quentin. He's got a big hole on the left side. He makes the man miss. He might have some space, 50. He's gone, 40, 30,
you're not
20,
catching him.
10, touchdown, Blue Comets. Q, Quentin Harding.
Just a little delay, opened up that hole.
81 yards on the ground for the touchdown. That's the big play you're looking for, Coach.
And changes the momentum for you.
And the big, following that big beef on the left side.
It just opened up, and then his speed. Once he's out in the open, you're not catching him.
Well, we talked about the beef on the lines. And that time, Quentin had a big hole and made short work of it. The Blue Comets take the early lead at 7-0. We'll be right back. You're watching Comet Vision.
KFEX Fire Escape Radio programming is made possible in part by the underwriting efforts of Sonic Drive-In of Chanute. Sonic Drive-In of Chanute does not consider community involvement a sales gimmick or a public relations ploy. They see it as a way to be a good neighbor and as a way to have a positive impact on their community. It is for these reasons that Sonic Drive-In of Chanute is a proud underwriter of KFEX Fire Escape Radio and the ministry efforts of the entire Fire Escape ministry to the youth of Chanute.
7-0, Chanute on top after an 81-yard run by Quentin Harding. Quentin Harding, 6'184" junior. And we talked about the beef on that line, Coach. That was a giant hole on the left side.
Just once it opened up, he had the eyes and the vision to pop it outside and get going. Stevenson had the extra point kick through. He's also kicking off.
Yeah, let's talk about Elliott Stevenson. Elliott, a sophomore, 6'2", 190-pounder, basketball player, great athlete. Smart kid, playing safety out there. He's directing defense. Now you got him. He's also the kicker. He kicked the extra point.
He was supposed to start at corner last year and got hurt. First game in the season.
Dealt with some injuries last season. Otherwise, he'd had extensive playing time as a freshman.
Everybody on your feet.
So here's Stevenson ready to kick the ball. Here it is. It's a little toe poke. And takes a good line. Bounce, stays in bounds, received it to 10. Here come the Orioles, boy. He meets a quadrio. That's not a real word. Of Blue Comets at the 20-yard line. A quadrillion?
Quadrillion. Well, that'd be a few more. A quadrant of comets.
There were four of them. All right. Kaiser leads his team back out on the field to try and answer that Blue Comet touchdown. The Chanute defense goes back to work. First and 10 for Augusta from their own 21. Gavin Kaiser hands it all ball off to their running back, and he is.
Great read by all four linebackers, but brought down by number 52, Hunter.
Yeah, he broke through the line pretty well. The line opened up a hole for him, but the linebackers were there in a hurry.
And the D tackle scraped down, just didn't get upfield and found the ball.
Looked like he was going to get more yardage, but the linebacker shut it down. Second down and a long six. We got 5:30 and counting to go here in the first quarter. Kaiser now fakes the handoff to the receiver, gives to Stillwell. Stillwell looking to beat him to the outside, and he's not going to get past Cade Small.
He seems to read that great, came up, played it. The running back did beat one tackle in our corner.
Yeah, you're right. It was Caden Seamster on the tackle. The 5 and the 9 on that font looks the same to me. But those are beautiful jerseys for the Blue Comets. Third down and 3. It's a big play for the Chanute defense. Try to set a tone early. Kaiser was still well behind him. We'll see what they dial up. Kaiser turns, hands the ball off. It is a different running back. It's not Stillwell.
Bilby all over that.
Landon Bilby.
He's all over the field, Dave.
Early on has been making the Orioles cry early. Number 4, Jace Tarter was there to help clean it up, but what a play by Landon Bilby. That'll bring up fourth down.
I think we'll put, wonder if they'll bring the heat now.
Jeremiah Schaefer back to punt again for Augusta. And Chanute in business as we go under 4 minutes here in the first quarter.
They don't show like they're going to come for it.
Back to receive for the Comets. Number 4, Jace Tarter. And number 5, Jake Caden Seamster.
Here's the snap. The punt is up. It's a nice high one again. This one is going to drop. Tarter elects not to receive it. And the coaches look like they're wondering why.
Yeah, that didn't seem like the best read right there. Sometimes it's hard when you're looking up and you want to make the right choice. And
yeah, it's tough. I can see playing it safe, you know, if you're not sure.
Yep.
And it is first game of the year. It'll take time to get the speed, just the beats of the game right. And unless you've done that, trying to field a kick, you don't really realize how hard that actually is.
11 guys running at you.
These kids will make it look easy. But trying to look where the pursuit is and look up to catch the ball is more difficult than you might imagine.
A lot of pros got cut this last week because they couldn't do it.
That's right. And a lot of guys that are going to be bagging groceries the next couple months because they couldn't nail that down. Of course, speaking of the pros, watching the high school game is fun because you imagine, you wonder, what's ahead for these kids? A lot of these kids, the vast majority of them, will not. This is where their football dreams end, on this field. But some of them will go to college, and you wonder if there's that one out there who will taste glory.
At the NFL level. It's been taking a lot of time between the...
Yeah, the officials...
Between our touchdowns when we kick off.
Given a little bit more time. Usually they expedite this pretty quickly. But it's the first game for them, too. So Chanute will take over at their own 31-yard line. First and 10.
Maybe they're doing it for the heat and the water in the first game of the year.
That could be. Could be. Always hot here in Kansas, that first game in August.
We got Trips left.
Trips to the far side. Chris Harding the second awaits the snap. Quentin Harding beside him. Here's the snap, the give to Quentin. Quentin runs to a giant hole up the middle. He's galloping again. Makes the move to the outside, and he's on the run. 40, 35. Breaks the tackle, 25. Makes another man miss, and is tripped up inside the 20. Quentin Harding is a man among boys.
Two plays, and he's almost up to 100 yards.
Oh, he's past 100, Coach. Yeah, he's past 100. Let it never be said we were good at math. So first and 10 in the red zone after another big run by Quentin Harding and Augusta back on their heels. As that line for Chanute continues to open up truck-sized holes. Here's the snap. Harding back to pass. Looking over the middle. Wide open. Seamster touchdown. 22-yard pass and catch. And they don't get much easier than that, Coach.
No, that was perfectly thrown where he could catch it, not the other defender. And Seamster watched it right into his hands.
The Blue Comets off and running here after a three and out on the first possession have now scored on successive drives. And Elliot Stevenson will go out to try and make this a 14-0 game. Snap, hold, and it is good.
Bilby had a nice catch on that. The snap was a little behind him. He brought it back into play. In the first,
14. Well, we'll keep it right here. Well, this is a 10. On a scale of 1 to 10, on ways you could start the first football game of the year, Coach Cleek Frizzell, methodical and dominating Chanute offense.
It kind of shows who might be in better shape.
You think so?
Well, I mean, the way our line opened up the holes, I mean, Quentin Harding.
Yeah, they're going to open up a lot of big holes like that this year. This is, look, I was down there before the game. And as I walked past the line, I was actually afraid for my life.
You was afraid.
If one of these men ran into me, and they are men, you'd have to send word to my wife because they would have crushed me.
They would have crushed you.
And I'm a big dude. But not like that. Those are hosses. Here is the kick. It's a little squib kick taken at the 21 after a couple bounces. Receiver, oh, nice little stiff arm, but it didn't work as the defender for Chanute, number 12, Isaac Dalton, stayed with it.
That was a nice way to grab a hold and ride on.
I'll tell you what.
That was a stiff arm.
Isaac got his head snapped back and still stayed with it, made the tackle. That's a pretty good effort. First and 10, Augusta on their own 30-yard line. So first down and 10 coming up for the Orioles of Augusta. And they find themselves in a little danger spot early.
All right,
they need a couple first downs to keep this ball out of Chanute's hands.
Number 20 is giving Stevenson a break at safety.
Here's Kaiser back to pass now. Now the rush, the ball's back up in the air. Almost picked off.
And that is picked off.
Nah, I don't think so, Coach. We got one official signaling the complete. I saw it hit the turf. They did a good job of acting. Brady Alonzo just about fixed that. It was Brady Alonzo who almost came up with the carom. I'm not sure who deflected it.
Think it was Smalls.
Cade Small.
Small.
Causing havoc in there. Second down and 10. Well, Augusta has shown a willingness to get back there and pass, but they're going to have to give their quarterback time. And so far, that's been hard to come by. Kaiser waiting for the snap. He's got Stillwell behind him. Here is a little option pitch to Stillwell. He's cutting back, got himself a room, almost breaks it. It was up to Quentin Harding to make the saving tackle, and he did, but it's a first down for Augusta.
But the DN, he was afraid to follow that. He thought there was should have been a linebacker there. He was there for the cutback. And maybe we had a blitz going. I don't know where the outside linebacker was.
So first down and 10 for Augusta. Now the give on the jet sweep. No, it's a quarterback keeper as he faked the sweep. Whoa, that's a big boy quarterback. He took a shot and stayed on his feet. But
Quentin Harding laid it to him.
Orioles number 9, Gavin Kaiser on the keeper.
Gavin Kaiser is a big guy at quarterback, and you're not going to be able to arm tackle him. You're going to have to bring him down. And the Chanute defense did that, just that, after the initial hit. Gain of 6.
Number 58, senior Quentin.
Second down and 4 upcoming for Augusta.
Second and about 4.
Kaiser sends a man in motion. We've got movement on the right side of the offensive line.
And then they called it against us.
They're going to say a defender moved into the neutral zone. So offsides, and that'll result in a first down for the Orioles. Well, he said that Augusta needed to come out, get a couple first downs. Get their defense some rest, break up any rhythm that Chanute had created. They're doing just that. Senior-led football team. They're not going to go away.
No. It was a war last year. We beat them dominantly, but.
Here's the give on the jet sweep to number 10. He's
nice
on the right side.
Nice block on the tight end over there.
Made a nice move to cut back. Isaiah Blackwell, another senior.
Isaiah Blackwell.
Gain of 6.
Gain of about 6 on the 5 on the play.
Brings up second down and 4. Augusta's offense has shown some ability to move the football. They just need to string together consistently good plays. You know, sometimes it comes down to not making a mistake to derail your good plays. Here's the pitch on a little option play. Stillwell got a nice block, but
there should be a holding call on that. Those of you guys watching saw him get thrown.
Yeah, he did get thrown, but number 44, Landon Bilby, there again, stopped him from gaining any more. And Landon Bilby, the junior, has been a standout on defense here early here in the first quarter.
We were just full of linebackers last year. He would have got a chance. He had the heart as a sophomore. We were just full of senior linebackers last year.
So third down and short. We'll get a good look at this line. We'll see if Augusta tries to run this up the middle. Use their beef. Here's a quarterback sneak.
Oh,
he went low.
Did
he drop that football? It's picked up by an offensive player, and he's not going to get close.
He didn't get it, no.
There's a fumble on the snap, and they just never recovered. So fourth down and inches. I tell you, they get lucky. That ball kind of squirts out to the wide receiver there, gave them a chance. All right, that's the end of the first quarter. Chanute leads at 14-0. You're watching Comet Vision. We'll be right back.
For years, Jared Gilmore and Phillips PA has been providing quality financial guidance to local individuals and businesses. Their expertise ranges from basic tax management and accounting services to more in-depth services such as audits, financial statements, QuickBooks support, and payroll. Jared Gilmore and Phillips PA has backed Chanute's youth in all their endeavors from the classroom to extracurricular activities. They're proud to help support the youth of Chanute by underwriting this KFEX broadcast.
Headquartered in Fredonia, Ehlert Construction Services was founded in Southeast Kansas as a small regional contractor and has now grown into a national heavy industrial construction company with regional offices across the United States. The Ehlert family is proud of our Southeast Kansas roots because we know that the people of Southeast Kansas make great employees. At Ehlert, we know that employees are our greatest asset, and we're committed to investing in the growth of our employees and our community. Ehlert Construction Services, proud to support the youth of Southeast Kansas through the Firescape Coffee House and KFEX Firescape Radio.
So on fourth and inches, Augusta runs it up the middle, and they're going to get the first down.
West on the carry. Looks like it's good for the first and 10.
So first down and 10 on the fourth down play.
32-yard line.
Augusta's drive will continue. First down and 10 from the Blue Comet 32. This is the deepest trip they've had inside Chanute territory tonight. Kaiser hands it off to the running back, and boy, he's going to get wrestled down in the backfield by Cade Small. And the Blue Comet defense up to the task early again. We've got a flag on the field.
Junior Cade Small dropped for a loss on the play.
They're going to call a face mask on that. Cade is asking for clarification. It looked interesting, but it looked like he maybe grabbed the back of the helmet. But it will result in just the 5-yard variety penalty. It's first down and 5.
First and 5. Augusta. On the blue comment, 27-yard line.
Kaiser, the pitch to Hunter West, and again in the backfield is Landon Bilby. I'm just going to start calling Landon Mike Singletary just for tonight. Is that all right? He is everywhere. Landon Bilby, the junior linebacker, having a coming out party here in the first half as he is announcing his presence on this defense. So they lose the 5 yards they got on the penalty, and now it's second down and 10. Hunter West, the running back in there for Augusta, a sophomore. So they're going younger back there. Here's Kaiser back to pass. He's looking down the field into coverage. It is caught. Well, what a catch and throw by Augusta. Kaiser had to put that ball in a certain place, and he did. And then the receiver had to make a great catch. Isaiah Blackwell, senior to senior. And the Orioles are on the board, and what resulted in a kind of a must-have for them on that drive, and it resulted in a must-have pass and a must-have catch, and, well, they just nailed it.
He got it.
What a play. So Augusta for the point after. Now we got a flag, as we might have a illegal procedure. This will send Augusta back 5 yards on the extra point attempt.
To the Orioles, the 5-yard penalty.
So now they'll put the ball down on the 15. That effectively makes it a 25-yard point after. Snap is back. The hold is down. Boy, the kick is up and true. I'm telling you what, Jeremiah Schaefer's got a leg. He booted that one. That looked like he could have backed him up 25 yards, and it would have been all right. At any rate, Augusta gets on the board, and it is 14-7, Chanute Blue Comets. Well, Augusta, we've mentioned, a senior-led ball club. A lot of seniors in this lineup. And they looked like it right there. They needed that drive. They had to have it. And they made it happen. And Chanute, any thought they had of, hey, let's roll this, now they're back in the dogfight.
Thank you.
Well, the Chanute offense has made it look easy on their last couple trips. We'll see if Augusta's defense can step up like their offense just did and get them further back into this football game.
Blue color bands on your beat. Oreo bands have these bits been an exceptional amount of energy this hot summer in the weight room. Training.
Seamster back deep with, it looks like maybe at number 13, is that Jalen Duncan? That's a freshman if it is. Here's the kick, and they send it back. Seamster will take it at the 11. He's up the middle. Makes a man miss. Now he's got another, got some room. He breaks it to the outside. It's a foot race. It's across the 50. He's got the kicker to beat, but that's not any kicker. That's a big man, and he runs him out of bounds. He had the angle, but a great return for the Blue Comets, but we've got laundry in the middle of the field. That's going to be a block in the back, I believe, on Chanute. It was close, but they got him. Block in the back. And Chanute will get their field position ruined.
There'll be a block in the back. Charge two, the receiving team.
So the officials walk it back from the spot on the foul. But still some good starting position for Chanute. So the penalty nullifies a big return by Caden Seamster. The offense, they just have more room now. Just have more room. Ball's placed at the 39-yard line, and that's where the Blue Comets will attempt to start their third possession in a row that leads to a score.
See if the offense can just drive down methodical and score again.
And here we go. Two wide receivers, a little bit more beef. We'll see what Chanute does here. Not a usual formation for them. Here's the snap. They give to Quentin. He's testing that right side. Bounces back in the middle. Spins, but he's wrapped up. Great tackle. Saves a lot more yardage by Devin Carroll.
Quentin Harding. It's a D lineman not giving up.
It's another first down, though, for Quentin Harding. His boy, he's got a lot of room. They got pulling linemen there. Just a big hole. Followed it right, cut back at the right time. Good instincts by the junior running back. Chris Harding brings in the play. And two wide receivers to this near side. Seamster and Owen Luttrell. Chris Harding gives to Quentin again. Quentin looking for room out the left side. He finds the hole and almost spun out of another one. But a good gain again on first down of about 6 yards.
Almost saved his balance on that one.
Well, early on, what you're seeing, and we knew this from last year, but what you're seeing is just a lot of skills by Quentin Harding. He's got great balance. He's got good vision, good instincts. And if the first few drives of this season are any indication, boy, they've got a good one in Quentin Harding back there at running back. Second down and four. Now we've got a stoppage in play and a timeout for Augusta.
Oh, we got a penalty. Some kind. Must have been encroachment.
They weren't even down and they weren't even set. I don't even know what was going on there. I just assumed that was a timeout. My mistake. So a penalty on Augusta makes it second and inches.
Looks.
I mean, he's got the right on the first down marker. Here's Chris Harding rolling out to his right. Boy, he's got a lot of room. And he tucks it and runs. And is down to the 30-yard line. So good run by Chris Harding the second. We get to see his wheels for the first time tonight.
But that was 77 to deep. Carroll caught him from the back. That D lineman's not giving up. Is he playing nose?
Yeah, Augusta's had some good defensive plays out there. I don't think they're a bad defense. I think Chanute offense.
No, it's
is
just dominating.
Good.
Right, yeah. There's a lot of, like we said, we got the beef where we need it, and there's plenty of talent and speed.
Chanute's offensive line is going to give a lot of people fits this year. First and 10 from the 30. Harding, handoff to Harding. Quentin this time wrapped up in the backfield. There's a good play by the Augusta defense, number 51, Gavin Ralston, a junior.
Harding hit in there initially by Augusta's number 41. That's going to be Blake Locke.
So a loss of one on the play.
Loss of one on the
rare
play.
Rare keeping Quentin Harding under wraps.
Inside, yeah.
We'll see if Coach Frizzell dials up a pass for the sophomore quarterback.
To maybe slow him down, stop the D from coming downhill so much.
He's got two wide receivers on the far side. Now a guy in motion, Seamster. It is the give to Seamster on the jet sweep. Makes a man miss, spins off a tackle, and it's near the first down marker. He's going to be just short, but a good run there on the jet sweep.
Smart play by number 55. He was following it. He didn't make any try to block for Seamster. Bring that one back on a penalty.
It was a great block by Quentin Harding on the outside to spring that.
Seamster waited for that block to happen and then hit his hole.
Yeah, very patience. Brings up third down and three. Most assuredly two down territory, I'm guessing. Four wide receivers, two on each side. Chris Harding awaits the snap. Here it is. It is a fake play action. He spins and rolls out to his left. Now he's going to turn on the jets. 15 runs it out of bounds. First down, Chanute.
Seamster came back in and got a good block, but the Harding was already aiming for the out of bounds to beat the corner.
It's so tough when you have a quarterback that can throw the ball and run, and now we're getting a good look at the sophomore. And boy, he just knew he could see the field and knew he had the wheels to pull that off and get an easy first down. First and 10 now from the 14-yard line. The Blue Comets threatening again. Man in motion. Here's the give to Quentin Harding up the middle, and the Augusta defensive line stands up to the test. Again, it's Devin Carroll in there.
It's a gain of five, though. Four?
It's about 4 yards. That's, I mean, I think you got to count that as a win going by what Quentin has done here in the first half. We still got 6.5 to go, and he's well over 100 yards. Number 23, Talon Haynes, was in there. Comes off the field.
We got two
backs. Trevor Fields out wide now. Junior, wide receiver, 5'10", 146 pounds. A little different shotgun formation here, and the give to Quentin. Going to his right, following Augustus Thuston, and he turns it upfield at the right time with a good game.
We had Small in the backfield going to try to get around the end and block that. But
what's that formation called, Coach? You're in the shotgun. You got guys. It looks like the old T formation in a way.
The bone.
All right. Wishbone, like a shotgun wishbone.
Let the bone roll.
They still call it? They still call it that? That seems old. Old school.
It is old school.
I learned everything I know about football from Madden.
From Madden?
Yeah. They stopped him just short of the first down. It's going to be third and about half a yard. I think you're going to see a healthy dose of Quentin. But could you see a little fake and a bootleg here? Use the wheels of the sophomore quarterback. Oh, they're awfully tight. And now they're just going to put it up the middle sneaking on the old Philadelphia Eagle quarterback sneak, and I think he got across.
Yep. Yep.
Touchdown. Chris Harding the second with a 5-yard quarterback sneak. Well, that's That's some impressive push by the offensive line. And the Chanute Blue Comets back out to a two-touchdown lead.
The sideline's got to be sitting, feeling pretty good about how well they trained and prepared.
Well, that's three straight possessions where they just kind of made it look easy to the Chanute Blue Comet offense. Here's the snap. Stevenson sends it up, and it goes through the, you know, sometimes it doesn't have to look pretty. You just get it through the uprights, and that's what Elliott did. That makes it 21-7. We'll be right back. You're watching Comet Vision. Chanute on top.
Whether you're completing home repairs, weekend projects, or planning your garden for spring, Cleaver Farm and Home, 2103 South Santa Fe, has a carefully selected inventory for all of your paint, hardware, and building needs. Cleaver's also offers free delivery for cat and dog food if ordered online at www.cleaverfarm.com. Cleaver supports the youth outreach of the Fire Escape Youth Ministry and is happy to underwrite KFEX Radio. Thank you, Cleaver family. We appreciate your support.
The Fire Escape Coffee House is dedicated to high school and college students. Our mission is for every student in Southeast Kansas to know they have value, they are loved, and that they have a place. We are not a church, but we are motivated by the love God has for all of us. The Fire Escape opened in 1998 and is open every Friday and Saturday night for high school and college age students. During the week, the Fire Escape is open to the public Tuesday through Friday mornings for coffee, catch-ups, or small groups like Bible studies. The Fire Escape Coffee House is proud to partner with the Chanute High School Tech classes on this broadcast.
High school teens, if you just saw the commercial, Fire Escape Coffee House open Friday and Saturday nights from 8 to 11 p.m. It's a fun place to hang out, have some coffees, way too much caffeine. Here is a pooch kick. And it's, argued over. Now it hits the turf, and he's in trouble and had nowhere to go. Well, there was confusion between the two returners for Augusta. It looked like a pooch kick, but it had some distance on it.
It got plenty of height. They were going for getting down the field and covering it. Like you said, got to call it and let that guy catch that. You guys both can't be sitting there.
Augusta takes over on their own 22. They're coming off a touchdown drive of their own. They'll try to keep that going.
It's going to be pretty interesting, the battle of the linemen, see who lasts longer, because they're both going both ways, the big boys.
I think Augusta, looked good on that last drive. I think they have seniority. They have some experience. So you saw that on the last drive. Kaiser back to pass. Throws to a wide open receiver. He makes a nice move. Now going to end up stuttering himself a little bit too much there. If he'd have kept going across there like he was heading, he might have gotten a few more yards out of that.
Quinton got that tackle.
That's going to be a gain of about 6 on the play.
He had a good juke. Just,
yeah. Really,
it's hard to juke a running back.
If you freeze frame it where that guy caught the ball and how wide open he was, I'll take 6-yard gain. That's actually best case scenario for the defense. Second down and 4. Man in motion. Kaiser has it. He gives that man in motion. Now he's looking. Nice little stiff arm. Springs him for a couple more extra yards across the 30-yard line. They'll place him right at the 30, looks like. It's going to bring up 2nd and 2. Elliott Stevenson forced him out of bounds.
That was a great read.
That's going to be a game of about 2 on the play. We're looking at 3rd and long.
Needs to run through him and not reach for him.
Ball placed on.
They say 3rd and 3 on the board. I'm going to call it 3rd and 2.5.
3rd down.
Caden Stillwell at running back. Kaiser calls for the snap. Here it is. He's back to pass again. Here comes the push. He's got room to run up the middle, though. Good read by Kaiser as he's spun down by Chanute defender Jace Tarter, who's having a problem with a cramp now. There's cramp number 1.
And we're not out of the first half.
First game of the season. We mentioned that at the top. You're probably going to see a lot of that tonight. These kids are all in great shape, but you got to keep those fluids going. We use them fast.
Burn here the electrolytes.
The dog days of summer in Kansas. We got an injury timeout. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. You're watching Comet Vision.
Okay, let's go again. Edgar! I got a
woman called Claudette Jones. Tell me about your vision.
At the end of the day, it's your classic coming-of-age story.
Gonna need more shipping labels.
All the gig speed, fiber-fueled internet you need to take whatever and make it big. Sparklight Internet, a stronger connection.
KFEX 93.1 FM and Comet Vision are excited to partner with Dr. Grant Gastineau. Dr. Gastineau graduated from Chanute High School and is committed to supporting the activities of the youth of Chanute. Thank you, Dr. Gastineau. We appreciate your support.
So Jace Tarter getting stretched out on the sideline there. I'm sure he'll return to action soon. Meanwhile, first and 10 for the Orioles. From their own 37. Kaiser back to pass again. Quick toss through the hands of the wide receiver.
Kaiser pass and
Ben Britton couldn't come up with that one. But another good solid play for Augusta. They just couldn't execute it. But he was open.
How's it? It's a pretty important drive for... Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, no, you're all right. When you're a D-back, first game of the season... I assume you're giving a little extra room. You don't want to get beat early.
No, you don't want to get beat over your head. So you're giving them. You'll let them catch it.
But even more so in the first game.
No, for sure.
Yeah.
Tightening it up.
Playing it safe. Number six out there on the coverage. That's Trevor Fields, a junior. Here's Kaiser on second and 10. He gives to the. No, he's going to keep it on a quarterback keeper now. And
great play by linebacker right there.
Quentin Harding stayed home. He made a great play, as coach pointed out. Third down and 9.
He went for his responsibility. He knew if he gave it off to that running back, he was too far outside, and he just was going to hit the quarterback no matter what.
Well, they tried running that jet sweep to bad effect early. Landon Bilby waiting for him on the outside. That time he kept and met Quentin Harding up the middle. And sometimes it's pick your poison.
Well, we'll see how well we cover right here, Coach.
Third down and 9. 4 wide receivers. Kaiser's back. Here comes the rush. Good
the
blocking.
Delay.
Now throws it up the middle. Oh, boy, the receiver ran a good route. He just couldn't hold on.
He had the first down. He was looking for more. And
Brody Haskell, a sophomore. Boy, he's going to hate that one on the tape.
Oh, no.
Well, it was a great throw by Gavin Kaiser. That was great. He stepped up and was kind of moving forward and unleashed a bullet. It was a tough one.
It was right to his chest. And the receiver was just thinking about getting upfield.
Impressive throw, but just through the hands of the receiver. That'll bring on the punting unit
hopefully,
for Augusta.
Hopefully we actually catch this punt and return get some yards.
Here's Schaefer with the punt. It's a nice high one again, and this ball's going to drop and take an Augusta bounce, and Elliott Stevenson will watch it roll.
That was a short punt. That one couldn't be fielded.
About a 50-yard punt.
Yeah, I'm not so sure that's a bad thing.
Some Augusta guys starting to cramp.
Yep. So 3:07 to go here before halftime. Schnoot leads it 21-7.
First and 10, Blue Comets on their own.
And the Schnoot offense will try to add some more here before the half.
Starting down the 27-yard line. Well, don't look like Coach Frizzell's missing too much from last year. It looks like they're rolling pretty good.
I'm telling you what, the first half couldn't have gone much better. And this Augusta team, they're not slouches. You can tell early on, this team's going to win some games.
Oh, they got beef too.
Schnute has played well here in the first half. So first and 10 from the 27. Harding and Harding, the law firm, in the backfield. Here's Chris to Quentin, the handoff. Harding up the middle. Got tripped up and then got the feet churning again for a gain of about 11 or 12 yards.
It don't matter where he gets hit. He gets 5 or 6 more yards.
Well, what you notice here early is his balance is so good. That was not a small shot. I mean, he got hit pretty good and just keeps his balance.
Kind of like Ty Lee last year. You couldn't tackle him.
Low center of gravity and just real, but we can tell the leg strength is just real sturdy. First and 10 from the 38. What a treasure it is to have a running back like that with 3 minutes before the half. Here's the give to Elliott Stevenson on the jet sweep. Stevenson carrying the ball for a gain of about 5 or 6 yards.
So way to wrap that in.
Sophomore gets his first attempt of the season.
He got his arm in and put it over the end of that, protect the ball when he wrapped.
Yeah, someone put their hand right on it. Yeah, he was secure with the football.
Good thing he had two hands on it.
Clock is moving, now under 2:20 before the half. Chris Harding the second, sophomore quarterback. Will he put the ball in the air? Not this time. The give is to Quentin. Quentin pushes his blocker out of the way and gets maybe one or two. So. The Augusta defense plugged it up good that time.
Third and one and a half.
Augusta's number 41.
Under 2 minutes to go here before halftime. Chanute leads it. 21-7. Now we've got a timeout. Looked like we had a Chanute player with an equipment malfunction. Someone lost his shoe. We'll keep it right here before the half. That was number 55, Canton Fitzmaurice. Canton Fitzmaurice, junior lineman, 6'1", 222.
And here we go. First three numbers are 6, 7, 4.
But you're evaluating. So the fun of the first game of the year, you're constantly kind of evaluating. And usually, I've done this for a handful of years. And usually the first game of the year, you're kind of parsing through a lot of mistakes, a lot of your first game kind of mistakes, though. Not big glaring ones, just kind of nerves, and you're working things out. There's not many of that. There's not much of that that's happened here. This is two well-schooled, well-run football teams.
Yeah, what's there been, three penalties?
I mean, yeah. It's been a pretty clean first half. This looks more like a mid-season game.
Yeah.
So, impressive work by the coaches getting these two teams ready. Third down and short upcoming. A big play for Augusta. If they can somehow stop him here, might force a punt at this area of the field with this much time left.
Be an interesting call.
Quarterback is under center. Here's the snap and the give to the tailback. Quentin Harding leaps over the line, and he's wrestled down. Boy, he looked like
– there should have been a face mask.
Looked like he had full face mask with Devin Carroll with ill will.
That nose tackle. He must wrestle, too, because he's got a souffle move.
That looked like a wrestling move right there. Oh, my. Oh, yeah, yeah.
It definitely was a face mask.
Hey, you know what? Ref didn't see it. He didn't do it. Exactly. That's what they told me.
That's how that goes, Undy.
Looks like in the scorebook, that's a great tackle. But it is a first down by Chanute. So first and 10 now as we go under a minute and a half to play in the first half. Now Chris Harding will go back to put the ball in the air. Now he steps up in the pocket as he's flushed and running forward. Makes a move to the left. Got some good yardage down across the 40 and finally brought down at the 37-yard line.
He had a first down by a gain of three.
And another player cramping up. That might be Jace Tarter again. Yep, it is Jace. And we've got another injury timeout, although not an injury, just a cramp. As he hobbles off the field. Well, now we're down to 1:14, Coach, but they are on the Augusta half of the field after that nice scramble by Chris Harding. And early on, what are you seeing out of Chris Harding the second?
He's not making any dangerous passes. He'll pull it down and run. He made that opening right there. He just saw a little glimpse. And
now we got a whistle and a flag down on the play, and our first mistake by the offense. Yeah, so it's a procedure call on Chanute. Yeah, you're right, Coach. So far, the sophomore taking the safe choice. Making the safe choice is a mark of a solid quarterback and belies his sophomore year. He looks polished.
And our coach isn't asking too much of him. And
not yet.
We'll get to see his arm maybe in the second half open up, throw a little deep.
Well, it's first and 15 now, and they've sent him back. The last couple times, we might see another pass here, although I wouldn't put it past Coach Frizzell to run a little draw with Quentin here. On first and 15, it is a little delayed handoff to Q, and he's got a big hole up the middle. He's got one man to beat, and he does 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown! Quentin Harding.
They shouldn't have sent their middle linebacker. You called the play, Dave. and 44 just went by Quentin Harding, and there was no one left in the middle of the field.
It's Q school time. The big Q, Quentin Harding, with a 41-yard gallop.
He'll be having over 200 yards tonight.
Now we're moving back. We got some laundry on the field again. So we got another block in the back, maybe. Well, that had no impact on the play. I'll just call it right now. Whatever happened.
That won't be a good day in film tomorrow.
Yep. That's unfortunate because Quentin was running up the middle. That flag is near the out-of-bounds line. So unfortunate for Chanute. Someone got caught in an unnecessary penalty. Oh, it's holding. And, yeah, just a little too much hands there, Coach. A little too much hands. So first and short for Blue Comets, and the snap kind of came late there, but nothing called, and now the pursuit's there for Augusta.
14 was through that line out. He must have.
Well, look like they're.
He shot the snap count.
Look like maybe there should have been a false start there as some people moved, but the snap didn't come. The snap was delayed a little bit.
Sometimes that center forgets. He starts worrying about who he's blocking.
Same. I was just thinking about dinner. And sometimes, you go blank. So now they're going to be backed up a little bit. The board says third down and seven, but the marker on the opposite side of the field says second down. So when in doubt, we'll go with the officials until he changes it. seconds to go here before the half. Well, what they've done, no matter what happens here, is they've kept the ball out of Augusta's hands. They're going to keep them from being able to make this any closer.
Yeah.
Barring some sort of disaster.
Be interesting to see if we just take it in with the lead, or does he throw one to the end zone right here?
Yeah, it'll be interesting. We'll likely see what kind of confidence he has in the sophomore kicker, Elliot Stevenson, by what plays they kind of call here. We'll see if they play it safe, just try to get closer, or if they attack the end zone. Third down and seven. Well, no, we're going to call it second down. As the official thing across the way still says second down. Here's Chris Harding. We'll see him put the ball in the air maybe here. He's back to pass. Here comes the blitz. He's got to get rid of it. He does. Unleashes one to the end zone. Just over the hands.
Should have been a late hit too, but.
Just over the hands of Caden Seamster. It was a good route and a good throw by the sophomore.
Harding popped right up. That just shows he's got plenty of arm. He was on the run. Threw that from like the 43, and it floated through the end zone.
Well, that answers the question that we had. He went for it. Went one to the end zone. Now we'll see. Comets. Trusting his defense, they might go for it here. Yeah, it's third down. 25 seconds to go. So you took a shot on second down. Now you have third down.
I like
now
that he took it.
Got some whistles, and we're going to have a timeout, Augusta.
Because you got Augusta guessing, because they didn't think that they were going to go for it. So for Coach.
Well, it's third down. It's third down. So they're going. They're going to keep it here. That's why they go deep. They go deep on second down.
Right.
They take a shot. Now we'll, I'm assuming, see some sort of either, what do you think here? You can go a crossing pattern, a little slant, or they do that. Sometimes that wide receiver screen can be effective. Although you're looking for about 8 yards, long seven.
That short screen we did at the beginning of the game got us 8 or 7 or 8 yards.
Yeah, Chanute.
You can do that delay draw with Harding.
Chanute still has one timeout left to play with.
You know it's four downs.
Right. But, yeah, 25 seconds. Anything in the middle of the field will probably result in a timeout.
Right.
But then from that point on, they'll be empty.
You don't have time to set your kicker up. Will it be a pass to the out of bounds?
It's also a possibility. I have to think that Augusta's cornerbacks will be erring on the side of caution. Chanute's shown a willingness to go deep. We'll see what they dial up.
Well, Augusta's got their other safety.
Here comes the blitz. Harding's going to have to get rid of it. They're going to try and force the sophomore quarterback into a mistake. Now he's going backwards, just throws one up, and it's going to be picked off. Well, that one we see the sophomore taking a lump. It's Harding. Maybe just should have thrown that one away. He was out of the pocket.
They sent the house to him. They had man-to-man coverage called.
Yeah, it's a good play call by the defense. With the sophomore quarterback back there, you're going to send the blitz. And right about there, he makes him a miss. And this is where things went awry. He takes that backward trend and then unleashes the ball.
Wasn't a big – I mean, that's not a dangerous pickoff because we got 15 seconds left.
You're not in
position to kick a field goal there. The worst thing was going to have to punt. So
you almost maybe think if you're going to do that, get it deeper.
Trying to throw it deeper, yeah, that's the only thing.
But 15 seconds left, and Kaiser is just going to hand the ball off to Stillwell. Stillwell's got some room, but the Blue Comets were sitting back.
Well, he stopped. He got a first down, so he's going to stop the clock.
A prevent defense, but he is not getting up. He is hurt, and he looks like he's in some pain. So we're going to have an injury timeout as they deal with the injury for the Augusta running back. Oh. Well, he got his hamstring stretched out.
Stretched for him.
We got an injury timeout. We will take it with him, and we'll be right back.
Cardinal Drugstore, located at 103 East Main in downtown Chanute, is a small-town pharmacy and gift store which includes an old-fashioned soda fountain. They specialize in compounds and vaccines. They also supply many types of medical items. Cardinal Drugstore is your one-stop shop for all of your healthcare needs. KFEX and Comet Vision are so grateful for your support. From kickoff to the final lap, from Pee-wee's to the weekend pros, our team of doctors can help with the diagnosis and treatment of sports-related injuries. Wherever you are in your sports journey, Labette Health Sports Medicine Team has the training, experience, and skill to repair, restore, and renew. For more information about Southeast Kansas' leading orthopedic and sports medicine program, go to labettehealth.com.
The Medicine Shop Pharmacy, located right across the street from Royster Middle School in downtown Chanute, is in the business of making you feel better, faster. With three licensed pharmacists, the Medicine Shop has the knowledge to know the right drugs and the proper dosage to ensure your safety. If you're not quite up to your game, Medicine Shop offers delivery to your door. The Medicine Shop, a proud underwriter of the Chanute Blue Comets.
Unbelievable! Sparklight is unveiling unlimited internet for just $25 a month. Get reliable 100 meg internet for just $25 a month for 12 months with unlimited data. That's unlimited internet. Call 877-469-3057 or visit sparklight.com/savings. Sparklight, a new breed in high speed.
Caden Stillwell, hate to see that, senior running back for Augusta. And you hope you just strained that hamstring, not tore it.
That's all we can hope for. He's having a hard time putting any weight on it.
And prayers up for the senior running back for Augusta. First game of the season, that's exactly what we didn't want.
Right.
I don't know if I've ever really seen anything like that. He just got kind of awkwardly fell.
Just
and
got
someone,
rolled
yeah.
up. He was carrying the body weight of the receiver that tackled him. So we got a cover four.
Meanwhile, Augusta's going to come up with some sort of play from their own 38 with 9 seconds to go before half.
This is a dangerous defense, though. You leave a lot of holes. You got five guys back that are fast.
Kaiser got the snap, and he gives on the jet sweep. A smart little play there, safe, and he's got room and is going to get out of bounds and stop the clock with 3 seconds to go.
Augusta's number 10, Isaiah Blackwell.
You're up to midfield now. Kaiser looks like he's got enough arm to maybe get a Hail Mary.
It all
now
depends on if he's got time.
The question will be, can the line give him enough time? although Chanute is only...
They're only going to send
with
three.
With three linemen right now. They're going to send everyone back.
One of their linemen or one of their linebackers.
I don't know, Coach, that I don't run a play where I try to hit someone in the middle and let him make some plays.
That's what I'm...
So here's Kaiser. Boy, it's going to be a quick throw to the outside, and he's got a blocker and some room over there, but here comes the rest of the defense, and they force him out of bounds, and that'll be the half.
That's the half.
So at halftime, Chanute leads it 21-7. Good first half for both teams, really. Blue Comets are on top here at the half. Stick around. Stay tuned. You don't want to miss the Chanute Blue Comet marching band. We will have that for you when we return.
Home Savings Bank is a platinum underwriter here at the Fire Escape Coffee House. Home Savings Bank has been serving the Chanute area since 1886. Customer-owned and customer-driven, Home Savings Bank, located at 214 North Lincoln Avenue in Chanute, Kansas, is here to serve all your banking needs. Whether your needs are checking, savings account, safety deposit box, lending, or online banking, Home Savings Bank is here to help. Home Savings Bank is located on the internet at homesavingschanute.com. Home Savings Bank is committed to the youth of Southeast Kansas and helping the ministries at the Fire Escape Coffee House.
Missing that human touch at your bank? At Community National Bank and Trust, you'll be able to talk with a real person. Community National Bank is small enough to know you, yet big enough to offer the best products. Your busy lifestyle requires banking options like mobile deposit and people-to-people pay. With locations in Southeast Kansas and Southwest Missouri, Community National Bank and Trust can help keep your finances safe and your spending smarter. Online at mybankcnb.com. Community National Bank and Trust. Federally insured. Locally awesome. Member FDIC.
Welcome back. You're watching Comet Vision. We're making way for the Blue Comet Pride marching band here for Chanute. Enjoy the halftime show.
Gentlemen, welcome to Chanute High School's Blue Pride Marching Band's halftime performance. Tonight's performance is under the direction of senior drum majors Aaron Maddie and Ava Campbell, and will feature Masquerade from the Phantom of the Opera and Dee Swizzle's You Belong to Belong With Me. Drum majors, is your band ready? Thank you. by Marching Band. And the next is Dr. A.J. Pugh and Ms. Rebecca Davis. And now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the Chanute Blue Comet Cheer Team. They will perform their first place routine from Cheer Camp. The Cheer Team is coached by Ms. Zoe Stewart. Team, your music is on. From the north end zone. We got a couple of big boots, Jackson Bond and Janet Knapp. Looks like we've had a change in the weather. We're going to make them kick against the wind going to the south end zone this year for the Comet Kick for Cash. I believe Dan Melfelt from Community National Bank is going to give about $5,000 for the winner. Well, maybe a little less. I think if you kick it through on the first kick, it's going to be a $50 gift. And if you get through on the second kick, $100. So here we go, Jackson Bond.
No worse boots.
Fans get behind him. He's got to warm up. Deep breath, Jackson. Let it rip. Boom! And it's good! I know. Former student Janet Knapp and kick. Wow! Give it that good bowler kick, Janet. Coming through. Get behind her, ladies and gentlemen. She's going through. She got whooped. Just a little adjustment. All right, Lucy, hold that ball right over there. God. Boom! There was some encroachment on a few worms in that artificial turf over there, Janet. Come on. You can put it through there. Jackson now moving back 5 yards. Looking for $100 bill. Kaboom! Hey, piece of cake. Janet has another one. Come on, Janet. Everybody say, come on, Janet. Come on, Janet. You can do that. Take a deep breath and in 3, 2, 1. Ah, woo! Halfway there. Janet, that was a great effort. Give it up for the Community National Bank. Call a kick for cash. Jackson Bond. Thank you, Blue Collar fans. Now we got just a few minutes. We've had a big, big row up here in the press box. We're still worried about their homecoming greens. Just for grins, if you're listening, do we have any homecoming queens in the audience? Look around. You may be sitting next to one.
Well, Coach, we had a halftime show, brilliantly done by the young people, cheerleaders dancing, band people playing, a good sign of the work they put in, so we celebrate those young men and women for doing their thing out there at halftime, and now we get to embark on a second half. The first half was a good one for the Chanute Blue Comets. We talked many times in that first half how it didn't really feel like a first game of the season. They did not a lot of mistakes.
No, they definitely came out rolling, and Coach Cleet had them fine-tuned to little errors. I mean, a couple holding calls and one face mask, one offside.
Yeah, there's a few penalties by both sides, but for most part, pretty clean first half for both teams. And both teams, Augusta, even though they're on the bottom side of this, 21-7, they had their moments when they look like, they're going to hang around. They're going to get the ball first here coming out of the second half. And if they can put on a little drive now, it looks like they're going to be without their starting running back, number 3.
Team down. We've drove on them twice. We've kept the ball. We just didn't finish. Can we execute right now and turn this into a one-touchdown game? What's interesting, Christian Newt came out here and smack them right in their mouth and pin them back.
So the Blue Comets set to kick off to get the second half underway. And Stevenson's got it teed up.
And here we go.
Here is the kick, and it is up and short. Taken at about the 16-yard line. Augusta Oriole following his blocks. Makes a move to the inside, but he's going to hit the end of his run right there. Got across the 25.
I wonder if that's what the way they call the kick, because he's not laying his whole leg into that.
No, it looks like he's maybe really trying to hit a spot.
Yep.
Almost.
Could be part of the special team plan so we don't lose it.
First down and 10 for Augusta. They'll start at their own 24-yard line. The running back in there now for Augusta is Hunter West, sophomore. He did get time anyways before the injury, and here's the handoff to him. He tries to win to the outside and tries to cut it back, and fumbles the ball. Ball's on the turf, and Chanute has it.
That was a great screen by Cash, senior linebacker. He just stretched that out to the sideline. Got help.
Well, it's a good run by the sophomore, but cut it back up and just didn't secure the football. Seamster got it in there.
He hit it out of his hands.
And a big, big error, what we talked about. There hadn't been any real big errors. But the sophomore running back for Augusta there puts that ball on the turf. And now Chanute in business to maybe break this game open a little bit here at the beginning of the second half.
Coach Rizzo usually likes to put it right in the end zone after a turnover like that.
We'll see. We'll see how what he chooses to do with his sophomore quarterback.
I bet you.
Harding and Harding in the backfield. Chris Harding awaits the snap. Here he is, and he is back to pass. He's looking. Now steps up in the pocket and tucks it. He's got room. Down across the 30. Forced out of bounds. Just past the 25-yard line.
Hey, Dave, who was on his tail? The nose tackle.
Well, I'm telling you, that nose tackle. Whew. I mean, you got that guy chasing you down. Devin Carroll. I'm not sure how big he is, but he looks like he's about 5'9", 250.
Yeah.
I mean, he's a big guy. And he's moving out there.
He's keeping up with the outside.
Like he stole his lunch money. He's coming after him. But the run is. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
It just shows the calmness of our quarterback to step up in there in that traffic and find his way to get a first down.
It is a first down and 10 now from the Augusta 24 after the turnover. This time he gives to Quentin Harding, trying the left side, spins off a tackle down to the 12. Another big run.
He switched the ball so the linebacker couldn't hit it.
Do we have a penalty on the field? Penalty flag? The officials confer. It is a hold on Chanute.
Clean over on the other side where the receiver is.
Now, I may be biased, Coach, because we're Chanute guys. But that's the second hold in a row where it looked like it was unnecessary. I don't know. Maybe we need to see it on the replay, but and not knowing exactly who they called that on, I have no idea. But he ran to the left, and there was no one out there. He was pretty much running away from the blocks.
It was the line coach, the defensive line coach, that called it.
So first down and 15 now after the penalty. And here's Chris Harding. Now a little wide receiver screen is dropped by Tarter.
That's one that you usually don't miss.
Yep, that one you could just tell. The helmet moved ever so slightly to get a look at where the defenders were.
Right when he was going to tuck it. And
that's the old catch first, then look. It brings up second down and long. And things get a little bit more interesting. Two receivers in the near side are Tarter and Caden Seamster, one to the far side.
D tackle in the backfield, small.
Now here's the give to Quentin Harding. Stiff arms, the guy to get loose on the left side. Cuts it back to the middle. What a cutback. And a good gain for Quentin.
He's 2 yards from a first down.
Well, that was just an incredible run. You'll see here on the replay that he went to the left side, and then it looked like he'd be wrapped up after about 5-6 yards and made a little cutback to the middle. He talked about his vision. The vision, the balance, the instincts. He's got the whole package.
He does.
Third and long, three. Connets just outside the Oriole 11-yard line.
A sub comes on. That's Elliot Stevenson as he gets the play relayed to him as they have trip receivers to the far side. Harding may put it in the air here on third and short. Here it is. He waggles out to his right. Now he looks, and he's got a man. Caught Seamster. Now trying to stay in bounds, but he'll get wrestled out. But the first down.
And that was a nice throw.
First down gained. A nice little toss and catch. They haven't asked him to do a whole lot.
there wasn't any risk there. I mean, it, yeah. Seamster coming across. Worst thing he could have done was throwing it out of bounds. So
first and goal now from the 9-yard line. Chanute threatening after a first play turnover here in the second half from the Orioles.
Think we give it to one of the Hardings?
It's a good bet, Coach. Harding and Harding, the law firm in the backfield. Here's Chris Harding, corner. No, it's Caden Seamster who's taking the snap. They got a little formation tree. Boy, he dances around. What a move. Well, he just never gave up on the play, Coach.
He was determined he was getting a touchdown.
And Caden Seamster is such a weapon because he played quarterback, took a lot of snaps over the years here for Chanute Blue Comets. So he's dangerous. He can throw the ball. He's not back there just as a runner. But he's a big kid, too. And, boy, there was no way he was just going out of bounds.
No. That was some nice juking and jiving.
So the touchdown, the extra point is good, and Chanute leads 28-7. You're watching Comet Vision. We'll be right back.
Want to take a chance to take a moment to recognize our Blue Comet sponsors, our super fans.
So the Blue Comets lead 28-7. The disastrous first play turnover by Augusta set up Chanute to bust this game open. They now lead by three touchdowns. Elliot Stevenson tees it up.
Blue Comet fans on your feet, Oriole fans up.
Here is the kick. It is high. Again, right at about the 15-yard line is where the Orioles will try to return it. Now, not getting away from Mr. Bilby. Well, Landon Bilby is a pit bull out there. He is not letting go once he's got you in his grasp.
He's definitely a linebacker. Good fill of that spot. He had to have 5 solo tackles in the first half.
Yeah, he's been all over the place. That's the first time we've mentioned him here in the second half, but it's only the – and they've only had one offensive play have the Orioles, so we'll see what happens here on first down and 10 for Augusta. Hunter West in there at running back. Again, he's the one who fumbled, the sophomore. He's in there because Stillwell, their starting running back, went down with an injury. Here's Kaiser running away. Boy, he's going to have to scramble now. Throws one late, and it was a good idea. We got a flag, though. This might be a hold.
It is a hold. Dave, hopefully we decline that.
Well, the receiver got
hammered
on the other side of the field as we got a Chanute player who's cramping up. But boy, the Augusta player just got hammered on the sideline there. The quarterback made a great heads-up play.
Initially, a gain of about 3-4. Looks like that's going to come back. Holding charge, too.
So we got a holding call that'll send it all back anyways and erases a heads-up play by the quarterback for Augusta.
That seems to...
Now that's number 6, Trevor Fields, who's cramping up for the Blue Comets. I'll bring him to the sideline, try to get him stretched out. First game of the year. We talked about how usually when you're seeing a lot of players with fluid issues, cramping up. Augusta moved way back now, all the way back to the 12-yard line. First down and 20.
This is where you watch quarterback delay, draw.
Yeah, they haven't sent him back for a big seven, like a seven-step drop much tonight. And the way that Chanute defense has been getting after it, you got to think that they're either going to run them out like they did in the last play or something quick.
Trips to the wide side.
We'll see what they elect to do with it. For Gavin Kaiser, the senior quarterback, he's back to pass. The blocking is good. He's got a pocket. He throws it, unleashes it, and caught. So good pass and catch right there.
Well, we almost had him. He stepped right past our
Bilby and Elliott Stevenson on the tackle.
Small, just one step too deep from getting the sack. He had it.
Kaiser was steady in the pocket, though, with it collapsing all around him and unleashed a great throw to an open receiver. When he's had time, he's looked skilled. Very skilled quarterback.
You can tell they're seniors.
Second down and four, so a good gain when they were backed up of 16. And Kaiser, now the option, pitches out to the running back, who turns the corner and has some room down the sideline for a first down. Hunter West. That's Augusta moving the ball again. Garrett Love comes in the game. Quentin Gregory runs off, as well as number 63, Peyton Hurst. So a couple seniors getting a little break.
Looks like he was chased out of bounds by Blue Thomas Quentin Gregory. That's going to be good for an Oriole first down.
Three receivers to the near side, this time for Kaiser. West behind him. Back to pass. Quick throw and catch as he receiver is getting some room on the side. So
that's his favorite receiver. I don't know if he's throwing to anybody else.
Gain of about seven. Toss to Brody Haskell. Brody, a sophomore wide receiver for Augusta. So with the senior leadership, you see some young players for Augusta. They got some promising young players too. This team's going to win football games.
Do you see three on the sideline?
I did not. Here's Kaiser in the pistol. Gives the jet sweep. Same receiver that just caught the ball, and he's going to have to work just to get back to the scrimmage. We got a flag. This might be a face mask. Defender might have got a piece of the face mask. No. They call it on Augusta. What did he call, Coach?
Looks holding.
Like, is it a hold?
Yeah. It was on 77.
Okay, well, it was a tough play, and those runs to the outside haven't really worked for Augusta tonight. The pursuit of the Chanute defense has been too fast. They keep trying to go to it. Now they're wondering whether they even want to send him back. I mean, the result of the play was a loss of about five, if I was looking at it correctly.
Yeah.
So they may choose to lose the down here. It is they call it a face mask on the offensive player. He must have grasped it instead of just the stiff arm, right?
Maybe.
Now, he can hit him in the face mask, can he? Yeah. He just can't grab it. See, I need help with the rules.
That was 77. That was the same one that got by with one earlier.
See, I need help with the rules sometimes.
Well, it all changes, too, after the play's out of the 3 yards of the line.
So it's third down and seven at any rate, as they take the result of the play. And Kaiser will go to work here. He's got four wide receivers. Now one in motion.
There's two moving.
Here's the snap. He's back to pass. Here comes a three-man rush. Augustus almost had him. Quarterback up there makes a man miss, and he's got a first down. So
one of our middle linebackers got to clean that guy's clock when they're coming.
Yeah, I mean, Yeah, I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying, Coach. That's a big kid at quarterback, and he's got some skills. But you're right. They had him. They just couldn't bring him down. That's they'll hear about it in the video room, I'm sure.
Well, Augusta's drawing him deep with five wide receivers, but
another penalty on the play is now we're getting bogged down a little bit. Now those mistakes start coming. I'm assuming we're going to have a holding.
So it'll be 10 yards back. Oh, only five.
Oh, an illegal shift. Oh, they called your call. You said there were two of them moving.
There was two
and
moving.
You were right, yes. So the coach was right, as he usually is. That brings up third and 11 now.
So we only got a three down line.
Augusta kind of fighting themselves now here early in the second half. Kaiser's got the snap. He's looking deep. He unleashes it one-on-one coverage, and it is almost caught on the sideline.
That was great, D.
It's a good coverage by Tarter.
I mean, a great pass. It was in his hands. He had the height advantage over his receiver.
Jace did a good job of hand-fighting him down the field and doing what he can to stay within the bounds of legality.
And he put his hand up right when the receiver went to get it because he wasn't facing.
And so much of that, those defensive back, and especially the cornerback positions, it's about doing everything you can up to the limits of the rules, right?
Yep.
Like what you know you can get away with, especially when you're outsized.
You're on an island, man-to-man.
Fourth down and 11, and Augusta will punt. Schaefer has the snap, and he gets an end-over-end short punt. It's going to take an Augusta bounce inside the 30. And Chanute will start their next drive from the 26-yard line.
Well, they're not kicking to us.
Yeah, it's interesting. I think we've seen Schaefer boot some balls. He's got the ability to do. I think that's intentional. They're not wanting any run backs on these punts.
We got a ticket to read for you. Oh, my goodness.
Get a good look at the beef of the Chanute line there. Quentin Harding has had a great game so far. He was over 100 yards in the first quarter, if I'm not mistaken.
For sure.
So it's a different kind of Chanute offense here that we've seen so far in this first game. Whereas last year you had all these pieces in place that made you more of a passing offense. We're going to take a break on a timeout. We'll be right back. You're watching Comet Vision.
Ticket number one.
For years, Jared Gilmore and Phillips PA has been providing quality financial guidance to local individuals and businesses. Their expertise ranges from basic tax management and accounting services to more in-depth services such as audits, financial statements, QuickBooks support, and payroll. Jared Gilmore and Phillips PA has backed Chanute's youth in all their endeavors from the classroom to extracurricular activities. They're proud to help support the youth of Chanute by underwriting this KFEX broadcast.
Thank you for your support of Blue Comet Sports.
Second possession for the Blue Comets upcoming here in the second half. They lead it 28-7. Chris Harding the second in the shotgun. He's flanked on either side. Here's the give to Quentin Harding. He cuts it back to the middle. He's got a lot of room. 40. It's a foot race. He's gone. 40. 30. 25. 10. 5. Touchdown. The big Q. Quentin Harding. 74-yard gallop by Quentin Harding, and it's the Quentin Harding Show.
That has to be close to 300 yards.
It is the Quentin Harding Show as he falls down on the sideline. I think he's goofing. He's tired. He's gotten a lot of work in, and he's possibly cramping up as well. Elliot Stevenson puts in the extra point, and his leg's getting a workout now. And Chanute leads it 35-7. One play, 6 points, and an extra point. And the Blue Comets' route is on now. We watch the replay. The cutback there is what frees him, and then it's a foot race, and Quentin's going to win that most every time. That was number 15 in pursuit.
Their corner almost took the right pursuit angle.
Yeah, Curtis Smith, senior for Augusta, showed some wheels of his own but couldn't quite get to him.
No, Clinton boated out. Be interesting to see if Coach starts putting some of the younger players in.
Well, he's running through huge holes. The linebackers were there, but once he made that cutback and eliminated them from the equation, it was on. And, boy, they're just going to do that. He's going to do that to a lot of teams this year. Again, like, look, Chanute's had some special players at running back. I don't know that they've – and this might be saying something, and this might be controversial. I don't know that they've had a player with the combination of the vision and the instincts. Like, last year, look, Ty Leedy, no one's a bigger Ty Leedy fan than me. But he did it on just want to, right? He has skills, of course. He's fast, but he's a wrestler at heart. Like, Quentin is making it so nobody even gets to him. He's got vision. He's making the right cut at the right time. There's some skills going on there that make him very, very promising. Here's a deep kick. It's on the turf, but picked up at the six. Now turns it upfield, and he's going to run out of real estate on the Chanute sideline.
So that's on the six. It's just got to be their special team plan. Keep it playable.
Well, and Elliot Stevenson's done a good job of keeping that ball in bounds while still playing around with the directional.
We're placing it on the hash.
Seems like.
Or the numbers.
Over the years, Cleet Frizzell has had a knack for finding a kicker that can just drop it on the 15 every time.
Right.
Wherever they kind of want to put it. That ball's usually on the 15 just about every time.
Coach Rudolph.
So maybe one of the most consistent areas of Chanute's team over the last handful of years has been special teams. 35-7 Blue Comet lead now. And here comes Augusta again. Kaiser has a man in motion. He gives to the receiver on the jet sweep, and this time he gets a handful of yards. Chanute defender was the guy that ran him out, and now he's cramping up on the sideline. Can't tell you who that was.
Looks like that's a good gain of about 6 on the play.
So they're looking at some scores. Parsons beating Prairie View 21-0.
That was Landon Bilby, of course, who forced the runner out, but he'll sit out a play as he works off a cramp. Second down to 5. Kaiser back to pass, unleashes one to an open receiver. Well, that was a nice pass with some zip, and a receiver makes a man miss before getting brought down by Caden Seamster. So number 11, Brecken Albert with the catch off a pretty good-looking pass by Kaiser. Just heard Iola was up at the half at 50-0.
Oh.
Coach David Doherty got his men humming in the early going.
An official timeout on the field.
It's a big rivalry, I'm told, in the past, the Iola Chanute thing.
Oh.
I'm told that. But they don't play each other anymore, which is kind of sad. As much anymore. Now, they have played a few times here in the past 5 years. So. Owen Luttrell was slow getting off the field. Seamster looks a little gimpy as well. It's hard, so hard to tell just how many of these players are struggling with cramps and how many of it is really getting dinged. I think the vast majority of what you're seeing is just cramping up by these players.
Yeah.
They're
just the first game. It's hard to imitate live, full man-on-man, varsity versus varsity.
Well, your adrenaline's flowing. You got the chemicals flowing in your brain, your natural chemicals. That's going to make your body work harder in and of itself, too. First and 10. Here come the Orioles. Jet sweep. This look on the pass. Jet sweep pass, and he's got a man. It's open. That was a nice play. And 15, if he can run the race. Here's Stevenson coming up quickly behind it. Oh, he almost made him pay for that early celebration.
Trickery.
Let me ask you a question. Is the early celebration what you want to do when you're down 35-7?
No. No, that coach is going to tell him.
That might be an interesting little moment in video as well tomorrow for the Augusta Orioles, but it's a good play, great play call.
Our DB came up to play the run.
He did.
And left a guy wide open.
Jeremiah Schaefer kicking for the PAT.
So that's a big touchdown that Augusta just very desperately needed.
That's a lot of meat on that PAT line right there.
The kick is up and good. And it's 35 to 14. Chanute.
Good.
You're watching Comet Vision. We'll be right back.
Kyle Gregg. Mr. Gregg looks like he's got some Thayer watermelon in that cooler. I don't know. I wish he did. That Coleman cooler belongs to Kyle Gregg. Congratulations, Kyle. Former Blue Comet.
Well, Chanute's defense has been charging hard on those outside runs. And Augusta caught him in one there with the jet sweep pass by the wide receiver, number one Brody Haskell, who's listed as a wide receiver slash quarterback. You saw a little bit of the skill there as he threw a strike to his receiver. And Augusta draws a little bit closer, 35-14. Here is Chanute struggling with the kickoff reception now. Now he turns it upfield and gets up to about the 14. Augusta trying to, their young men trying to get each other pumped up and see if they can make a little run here. 6:15 left to go in the third quarter. Still a lot of time. And just the ever slightest bit of momentum for the Orioles. Out comes Chanute's offense to take the field again. So four wide receivers for Chris Harding the second. Quentin Harding beside him in the backfield. Here's the snap and the give to Q, but this play is whistled dead. We've got a false start on the offense. So the Blue Comets will back up.
Going to be a false start, charge two, the Blue Comets.
They'll make it first down and 15 as they move them back to the 10.5 yard line.
Comets just outside the 10 yard line.
Chris Harding the second jogs in with the play from the sideline. Well, the offense largely on the back of Quentin Harding tonight. We'll see if he gets another opportunity here. The give is to Quentin up the middle is, oh, big paw put on him by number 76, Cooper Jay, a senior defensive lineman, and just grabbed a handful of his jersey as Quentin was running by and did not let go. So good defensive play there for Augusta. Makes it second down and long.
Gain on the play, going to bring up a second about 13 Comets.
We'll see what Coach Frizzell elects to do here. Gain of two on that last play. Here's Chris Harding dancing around the backfield. Now out of the pocket, lets one go just over the head and intercepted. And boy, he was hammered by Caden Seamster, but the young sophomore throws his second interception of the game as he just threw it over the head of an open Caden Seamster. So some growing pains for the sophomore quarterback will put the defense in a back-against-the-wall situation with Augusta looking to build on that little bit of momentum they gained on that last drive.
That's going to be an Oriole pick. Deep in Comet territory.
So an interesting turn of events as Gavin Keisner leads his offense back out on the field. Hunter West behind him, and now we got another flag. as it's raining flags here in the second half. Hallelujah. So they'll scoot them back 5 yards. Same way the Chanute drive started off. First and 15. Three wide receivers to the near side now. Haskell, Albert, Kaiser back to pass. He's looking, now steps up and shuffles one up to his receiver. Good pass and catch, breaks the tackle, spins, finally wrestled down at about the 5. So some good individual effort there by Brecken Albert, sophomore wide receiver.
Good gain on the play.
Another player cramping up on the far side. So Augusta will have first and goal when we come back off an injury timeout here. .507 to go here in the third quarter. There's still a lot of time left. And on this way, on a way to this Chanute route, we've hit a hiccup. And Augusta can get right back in this game with a touchdown here. Owen Luttrell, the player, struggling with the cramp now. The trainer's getting a workout for these two teams tonight. First and goal for Augusta from the 5-yard line. Kaiser all alone in the backfield. He's got 5 wides. Here's the snap. It's a quarterback draw, and he's going to be wrapped up. Well, the defense wasn't fooled on that one. Number 59 was there. Garrett Love, Jr., also Landon Bilby. Everybody stayed home. I think that was the first time they'd lined up in that 5-wide formation, and I don't think the defense at any point thought that that was going to be a pass. So brings up second and 6 now. They lost a yard. And again, an empty backfield. As the referee is, now he winds the clock. Kaiser, here's the guy on a run, and now we're going to have another procedure penalty. Well, Augusta had a prime opportunity that they're moving backwards on now. It's going to be third down and goal from the 11 now. The second down and goal, excuse me. Now they're back to their more of their base formation for Augusta with the running back West. He goes out wide, but Kaiser's back to pass. Now looking, flushed out of the pocket, lets one go. He's got a man, and it is. Oh, what a play by Landon Bilby. Bilby stayed with him, and when the receiver went up to catch the ball, Bilby put his hand right on it.
He played that great because the first guy went by him, and he played the flats. The quarterback rolled out, and that's when that receiver busted behind him.
Landon Bilby has been special tonight. Another big defensive play by him. They're asking him to keep up with a wide receiver there, and that throw is just a tiny bit late, Coach. Otherwise, he might have been in a tougher position. So there was a penalty on the play, and the Chanute Blue Comets have declined it, electing to take the down. So third and goal from the 11-yard line.
They got to be close to delaying you.
Yeah, we're 10 seconds on the play clock as they run up to the line. They're going to have to get set in a hurry. They're not Those receivers not getting up the line fast enough. Now they put a man in motion. I don't know if any of those guys were set long enough, but they let the play go. Here's the pass to the outside receiver trying to dance around, but he's going to be inside or the 7 or 8. There is a flag down, and I'm wondering if that's a procedure penalty again.
It had to be. There was movement everywhere.
Yeah, it's an illegal shift. Well, the receivers were just not getting up to the line fast enough. And then the quarterback didn't recognize that and sent that man in motion, and he had all sorts of movement. So I don't know if
I think that one's on the coach, though. There was two coaches on the field trying to draw up the right play to score.
Yeah, they came out of that huddle real late.
Yeah.
But they didn't.
You're right.
It's a compound mistake.
Right.
Because they come out of the huddle late, and then the receivers didn't act like they were coming out of the huddle late.
No hurry.
Third and 16 after all of that, and Kaiser's got his work cut out for him.
Watch the wide side slant here.
He's back to pass. He's looking at that slant. Now delivers over the middle, and was that caught?
He said it was.
It is caught, but he's down at around the 2.5-yard line, 1.5-yard line. Now they're going to rush up to the line and try to catch Chanute Knapp and not let them get into position. Kaiser takes a snap, and, we got whistles again. And another flag. They weren't set again, coach. Oh, my goodness.
3-1 play.
Oh, my goodness. No, it's offsides. The call is offsides. Now, why is that a stoppage then? Why is that a stoppage? Did they say he went in the neutral zone early? Did someone jump?
We must have been lined up. Uninvaded.
It's half the distance, and it results in the time to set up anyways. I don't know that that's a bad penalty for Chanute. At any rate, it's fourth and goal from the 1-yard line or inside the one.
We got to sub in a meet for the nose. So
yeah, I don't think that's a bad penalty for Chanute at all. And I'm just wondering why it's a stoppage. So Kaiser probably looking at the quarterback sneak here as he pushes. Boy, he gets it on the second effort.
Only rolled off.
In the end zone.
So Augusta scores the touchdown on the half-yard quarterback sneak, and they've got some energy now as they get back to within two scores.
Their kicker's showing that he's tired.
There's a little bit of chippiness going on down there after that score as Augusta's getting their confidence back up. This score comes courtesy of a turnover by Chanute, the second interception of the game for Chris Harding the second. Now we got another stoppage. We got a procedure call on the defense. I don't even know what's going on anymore.
they're flag happy.
Well,
we had
such a clean first half, Coach.
It was so good.
And the second half is all that. Boy, they're going to spend so much time on the second half in the video room. Oh, my goodness. That high snap. This one is up, and it is good anyways. Well, that was a great job by the holder as he had to get up out of his stance to field that ball and get it down. At any rate, 2:57 to go in the third quarter. And Chanute's lead is down to 35-21. Well, that's why it was chippy. Cade Small followed through on the rest of that tackle and wrestled him down, and they didn't like that. Well, we have a football game.
I was going to say, it makes fourth quarter coming out a little more interesting.
This third quarter has felt longer than my sophomore year in high school.
Usually when it's running,
it's felt longer than a bad date. It's felt longer. Well, anyways.
Well, you think they get tricky on there?
I don't know.
Kickoff?
Boy, you... you get your momentum feeling like this, and you know you didn't. You're not having much luck at starting Quentin Harding. I don't know that you don't try something here on a kickoff. Try to catch Chanute napping. You know, this new team in a lot of ways is young. Maybe you try something here. Maybe you try an onside kick.
Well, they're experienced seniors. You'd wonder. He's got it angled.
They've only got the normal kick return thing going here. But
he scooted this five out, so.
That ball's awfully upright on the tee. Now the official runs in. I'm not sure what's happening here as the coach for Augusta is talking to the official on the sideline. Now we're ready.
Oh, because their quarterback got tackled in the end zone.
Oh, is that what he's talking about? Okay.
Well, that number nine was standing right by him.
It is a pooch kick, but this is going to go out of bounds, way out of bounds. And Shuba, boy, there is some big hitting going on down going there. Some big hitting. And the Augusta player did not like taking the shock of that hit. But
no.
And then that's kickoff.
That was smart of his teammate, get him in and get him out, because the penalty had already gotten.
61, Jordan Harris, a freshman. Reacted to getting, kind of slobber knocked. Like, look, kickoffs are hard, man. You're running full speed. And
if you don't have your head on the swivel, you're usually getting it knocked off.
So I feel your pain. And they're taking that young man off the field right now. Let him
cool down
a little bit. Chanute offense back on the field now. We'll see how they react, see how the young sophomore quarterback reacts to that last interception. We'll see if that affects the play calling. They've been letting him put the ball up. Let's see if maybe there's a tendency to just hand this ball off to Q here. Here is the give to Quentin Harding, and he's hit hard but spins off it again with that balance, but the defense is there to wrestle him down after a gain of two.
Trying to see the number of that linebacker. He had a great read.
Well, the defender on Augusta took the brunt of that, and he is very gingerly walking away. We'll see if we can see what happened on the replay. It's on the second one, and
14, it took his helmet right to his chest.
Well, the defender, he gets kind of rolled up on in a weird way. Now he's making his way off the field. Number 14, Logan Pfeiffer. He's a senior linebacker. Meanwhile, second down and 8 from the Blue Comet 37. Now another whistle and another flag. This is a delay of game. And the mistakes continue to pile up here for both teams. So a gain of 2 on
the
running play is now minus 5 on the penalty.
Looks like a delay of game.
I don't think.
Blue Cox, 52-yard line. 54, Keaton Clark bends down over the ball to snap this one back to the quarterback. Here is the sophomore unleashing one. That's a strike to Caden Seamster, who's hit out of bounds after a good game. Out to the 41-yard line or so.
He had all the time in the world there. The line gave him plenty of time. So
it's going to bring up about 3rd and 4. That's a nice, you're not asking him to do too much there.
That's that one safe to the outside.
When you made him stay in the pocket, he's looked pretty solid. It's when he's gotten out of the pocket where he's gotten himself in trouble. And 3rd and 4 upcoming. Every play in your repertoire here. Run, pass, screen, draw, quarterback draw. Here is the handoff to Q. It's just a straight handoff, and Quentin's going to get the first down. And Moore dances to the outside, makes a man miss. Now spins inside the 40-yard line. They've had no answer for Quentin Harding tonight.
If his feet aren't running, if they're not going forward, they're jumping up and down, spinning, jumping sideways.
You just can't. But it was a little similar to Caden Seamster on the sideline earlier. You cannot expect that either of those two young men are going to just go out of bounds.
No.
Because it looked like he had nowhere to go. And he's like, no, I'm not going. I'm going to spin and try to get a couple more extra yards. And that's exactly what he did. So you see the replay here of Quentin coming into your living room. Right about here, they kind of let up and thinking he's going to go out of bounds. And no, he spins and instead runs you over, linebacker. First and 10 from the 37. Here's a little wide receiver screen to in stride. Pass and catch. We got another flag on the field. Owen Luttrell had the catch, but we got a penalty on
number 75.
Is that an illegal shift again?
No, Houston holding at
77 for Augusta.
It was 75. Like he
took a shot on
us.
The play. Devin Carroll, he's had a good game. Made a few big plays. We'll see if we can kick, see what happened there to number 77. Is that what they threw the penalty on,
15,
Coach?
Yeah, they had to clean his clock.
Oh, it's a crackback.
Yep.
It's a crackback block, okay.
Crack your back, yep.
So a crackback block called, and number 77, he did take a shot apparently. But they got caught and they're moved back 15 yards. And it'll be first in Arby's.
I don't think that gets called if it was in the heat of all the battle, but it was just right out in front of the white hat.
So now the Blue Comet's backed up with some work to do. Chris Harding the second awaiting the snap. He's got it. Hands off to Quentin. Quentin picking his way through, spinning across the line and wrapped up and gang tackled and stopped there. These refs are doing a good job of blowing that whistle quick. Things were getting a little chippy there after that last touchdown, and these officials are keeping control of the game well. Sometimes you get those crackback blocks and things can get heated. They're doing a good job. Sometimes it's hard to forget. Like, these are modern-day gladiators. This is a physical, adrenaline-rushing sport, and they're running fast. These kids are bigger, stronger, faster than we were, and especially than our parents were.
Oh, yeah, and the training just keeps developing. And but what college was 10 years ago, now high school is. I mean, we have TV on the sidelines.
That is the end of the third quarter. Chanute. Lead has shrunk a bit, but they have the ball. It's 35-21. We'll be right back after this. You are watching Comet Vision.
Alert Construction Services was founded in Southeast Kansas as a small regional contractor and has now grown into a national heavy industrial construction company with regional offices across the United States. The Alert family is proud of our Southeast Kansas roots because we know that the people of Southeast Kansas make great employees. At Alert, we know that employees are our greatest asset, and we're committed to investing in the growth of our employees and our community. Alert Construction Services, proud to support the youth of Southeast Kansas through the Firescape Coffee House and KFEX Firescape Radio.
All right, we're back for the last quarter of play. Chanute facing a second and long, second and 22. Here's Seamster in motion. It's a give on the reverse to Elliott Stevenson. Boy, he had nowhere to go. He slipped and that linebacker was in a great spot.
He stayed at home. That was going to be a double reverse. Surprisingly, he didn't follow Seamster.
So a loss of three on that play, it looked like. And a very long third down play upcoming. You know, where we got a penalty, too, and that's declined. So the second half has been a much rougher half so far for both teams. Lots of penalties. Very long third quarter. Almost as long as this third down play upcoming.
It's amazing the sliver that came off your full moon just in one night.
Trips to the far side. We'll see what Chris Harding the second has for the defense here. He's back to pass, lets one go, has a man, turns it short. Boy, he couldn't spot it. It was thrown to the outside.
It was through behind him. He turned to the inside to look for it, to find it.
Luttrell couldn't find it, and that's going to bring on the punting unit. And now things are getting interesting, Coach, as Augusta will get the ball back down two scores here with 11 and a half to go in the game.
See if we should be able to punt this inside the five and pin him there. Think Seamster can do it. Angle punt.
Unleashed a good punt earlier. Augusta at least pretending like they're going to bring a rush. They don't. And this is a small line drive kick that takes a side bounce. And boy, the receiver acted like he might want to touch it, but he didn't.
The snap rolled back to Seamster. That makes it hard to kick.
And so first and 10 for Augusta. The Orioles will start at their own 22-yard line.
22-yard line on the first and 10. Augusta on their own 22. Augusta's
huddle. Well, at times, Chanute has been the dominant team here tonight, but a couple mistakes have allowed Augusta to get back in this game, and Augusta has, even though that at times you could say they were being dominated, it wasn't that they weren't capable.
Right.
And Kaiser back in the gun. He's back looking to pass. Lets one go. And coverage is there and over the head of the wide receiver. Well, good coverage by number three, Owen Luttrell.
Brady Haskell of the Orioles over his head.
Different running back in the game that time for Augusta. Try and get his name. Looks like Jaden Harris, a freshman, was back there. So earlier in the game, their starting running back, Caden Stillwell, went down with an injury.
Seems like the coach is going to the air. He likes number one.
Yeah, he's going to go with his senior quarterback, Gavin Kaiser. Now Kaiser is the option. He pitches it out to the freshman, and he's got some room to the outside before it's shut down by Caden Seamster.
Great tackle by corner and the Seamster. That was the DN sliding out.
Yeah, they have that one wrapped up pretty good. Gain of three.
That was a great play by
Peyton Hurst, senior lineman, 6'2", 268.
Way to scrape the line.
You see big Peyton right there. Now we have a stoppage and a timeout for Augusta. Augusta wants to talk about this third down and seven on the way. We'll keep it right here. They need to be careful here, Coach. They're in striking distance, third down and seven, but you don't want to turn the ball over yourself.
Chanute's got to keep, they can't be playing on their heels, though. They got to come downhill and shut them down.
Yeah, you figure that they absolutely need
to
put the ball in the hands of their senior quarterback.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know if we know anything about the freshman running back they got in the game right now or the sophomore they were playing earlier.
So they got a sophomore. Their number one's their sophomore receiver. Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe give your senior quarterback an option pass run type play. I'm sure the Chanute defense is getting versed on all that by the coaches, that for whatever you're about to see, it's probably going to be in the hands of number nine, Gavin Kaiser.
They got linebacker Bilby on the wide side. I wonder if that's for a reason.
So third down and seven. Chanute leads by two scores, but it was much more than that at the beginning of the second half.
Third and seven.
We'll see what Kaiser can do here on third and seven. Important play for Augusta. He's back, pump fakes. Now let's go one, and it's...
That was a good
incomplete.
That was a good play. Tartar was there.
Yeah, again, good coverage. Good tight man coverage. And boy, there just wasn't. He would have had to have the receiver make some kind of special play.
The quarterback was smart, put that where Tartar couldn't intercept it. But
well, and Kaiser didn't have a lot of places to go there. The coverage was good.
Be interesting to see if they make a mistake here and give us a chance to show our wills.
We got the returners moving up here as they're now they're being, the coaches motioning them back, and they're just not even going to attempt to return this as they just watch it bounce. Well, they were worried about a fake there.
Yeah.
But it is an okay-ish punt. It's not great, but not bad.
Left his foot at the 10-yard line. I mean, they don't get credit for that, but.
And so Chanute will take over, and I'm assuming you're going to see a steady diet of Quentin Harding here. The situation is you're up two touchdowns, 35-21, and Augusta's had some of the momentum here in the second half, but they've had no answer really for Quentin Harding tonight.
No.
And you've got to figure that Augusta knows that if Chanute scores again, that that's going to wrap things up.
They got Smalls in that offense. Well,
neither team has used a timeout left, so Augusta still has all three of their timeouts. A lot of players struggling with cramps tonight. Landon Bilby now getting stretched out on the sideline. It's first and 10 for the Blue Comets from their own 38 on an important drive to try and salt this one away. Harding's got it. Chris Harding, that is. Now he waggles out. Nice, easy pass to Seamster, who's had a busy night out there, wide receiver, and he's hit right at the sticks.
And he gets first down. It'll all depend on where he marks it, but he was.
Well, Seamster so fast. Now he's slow to get up over there. He might have a cramp as well. Seamster's such a big target, but fast. And they got to give him that room. But he's such an easy big target to hit when you're giving him that room. And that's just a nice, easy catch. And as we see over there, yeah, he's just struggling with cramping up again, as a lot of players have tonight. So he'll be okay. Well, it's interesting sometimes, usually in this first game of the year, some guys keep cramping up, but they're okay. And then some guys, they get that muscle gets so tight, that calf or the hamstring, and that it's just they don't look quite right for the rest of the night. I haven't seen anyone like that so far. The guys that have gotten cramps look like they're going full speed after they get it stretched out. But it can affect you.
Yep, it can put a lock in there.
Just all kind of depends on tight the muscle pulls. So it's going to be second down and one. They mark just shy of the first down, which, all right. That looked like he was right on that stick, but we'll go with it. Just another play you get to run.
Yeah.
More time off the clock.
Helps you get a first down and keep the clock rolling.
Second down and one. We'll see what they elect to do here. Maybe on that right side where you've got big Gus Thuston. An all-state tackle. Here's the snap. Here is the handoff to Quentin here. It is up the middle, and he's got room again, making guys miss. Tackled from behind down near the 30. Oh, my goodness. Coach, they have a find in Quentin Harding.
We wondered as a freshman when he would get his opportunity, and then he got a few runs. And
oh, my goodness, he is having a special night.
And he set his time out behind Leedy last year.
I mean, he's going to end up with more touchdowns than my days attended of school my senior year.
What's that saying, Dave?
Stay in school, kids.
Stay in school.
First and 10 from the 31. Here's the snap. Back to passes. Chris Harding the second. It's a good one on a slant.
That was a nice play call. Got Seamster coming across. Hit slant.
Chase Tarter on the receiving end of that. That was another good-looking pass. When he's been in the pocket, Chris has looked good. He's looked solid.
It's hard to throw on the run for a senior quarterback, let alone a sophomore.
Yeah, his last interception, Coach, it just looked like he was on the run, and he just put too much on. It was too much gas, and it went over the head of his receiver. First and 10, now from the 15, as the Blue Comets threatening in the red zone. And Augusta down to their last gasps here. Now here's the give to Q. He's to the right side, gets a block. Now he's going to walk into the end zone.
Man, that was great block by Small. D.N. Small's playing fullback. I guess he would be playing H-back.
Well, you'll see it on the replay. Cade Small, the defender, had no chance of even putting a hand on Quentin Harding.
He drove him all the way to the sideline.
And Quentin Harding gets his 23rd touchdown of the night. I don't know how many. He's got a lot. It is 41-21. And the point after is up, and it is good. Listen, all Elliott does is poke that through and then run right back to the sideline. That's a dependable guy right there.
To kick your kick off.
No emotion. Just kick it through. Come back. Chanute has doubled up the score of Augusta now. Now a little breathing room. It's 42-21 after it looked like Augusta had all the momentum in the world. And Chanute really needed that drive, and they got it. Got it done. 9:04 to go here in the game. And that hill that Augusta needs to climb is looking a lot more steep.
It just got rained on.
It's uphill both ways in the snow, barefoot, y'all.
A little muddy. Well, let's see if he puts it on the 15.
Well, what a great night for football. Full stands here in Chanute. Everyone out having a good time. All the teams put in the work. Cheerleaders are cheering. The band is playing. The students in the student section out in force supporting their team. Is there anything better than high school sports, Coach?
No.
In a small town?
No. It brings everybody together out on a Friday night.
Here's the kick by Elliott Stevenson. The ball's going to hit the turf, but take a good bounce up to the returner, and he's got some blockers, but is hit just across the 30.
Surprised he put his hands up to stop that, and he didn't try to see if it'd bounce out of bounds.
Yes.
He's a senior. He's wanting to get a return.
Yeah, but it's tough. I mean, that's a quick decision he has to make there, because if that doesn't go out of bounds, he's in trouble.
Right.
So here's the situation. Chanute has upped their lead back to 3 scores with 8:55 to go in the game. Augusta has been up to it. They've provided a challenge, but they're on the bottom side of it, looking up a big hill right now. Here's the snap and the give to the receiver in motion, and he's wrestled down from behind by number 58, Quentin Gregory, a senior. Now we got some more chippiness going on between the players.
So they brought 24 up on the line. He was just off the line, so he's a running back. They helped open that delay open, brought Smalls out, brought our linebacker out.
Second down and looks like about 6. Kaiser back to pass, unleashes another good strike, but the receiver just dropped the ball. Oh, boy, he's going to not like watching that one on the tape. That's senior Ben Britton.
Oh, he's
That's the worst kind, too, because it's not only the drop it, you still took the hit anyways.
Yeah.
You might as well just caught it.
Got it, because three of them hit him.
That's a bummer. But Chanute will take it. That makes it third down and six. This is obvious four down territory for Augusta, though, as we're at 8:12 left to go in the game, down three scores. So third and six from the 37, their own 37. Safeties cheat up a little bit now. Kaiser back to pass, pump fakes it to try and get himself free, and did get himself enough room to get the first down. A nice scramble there.
He chose that on his own.
Yeah, he just gave it looked like he wasn't going to get that first down. He gives a little pump fake as he's passing the line of scrimmage, and I think that stopped the linebackers just enough. As you watch, he'll step up and right. Well, nope, he tucked it. But he did give a pump fake. I promise, yep. I saw it.
It was right when he was cutting around the line. Chanute's got to stay tight here. We don't want to give it up one.
First down and 10 as the clock continues to roll. Kaiser back to pass. And he gets it away. Nice little sidearm throw there. Quentin Harding on the tackle. That was a nice tackle. He's got some room to go if he doesn't make that tackle. Brody Haskell with the catch, the sophomore, and a little gimpy on his ankle. Looked like maybe he got rolled up on a little bit. But second down and four upcoming, and Augusta moving the ball a little bit.
He keeps calling plays that's keeping them in the game or moving.
Yeah, they're not getting much down the field, but they've managed to contain the pass rush a little bit better here in the second half. Maybe Chanute getting a little tired. Here's Kaiser in the bootleg. Now he lets one go across the field, but really had no one to go to there, Coach.
That was great play by Nathan Wilson. He played that to the flats.
We may have a flag down. And it's a roughing the passer call on Chanute. Well, that's not what they needed. Well, that's another bad mistake. All they have to do is not make those.
Yeah.
And get out of here with your win. But they're extending the drive and giving them yards, which is exactly what you don't want to do, and stopping the clock.
I was trying to see who.
It's like if you're going to let them move down the field, you want the clock to keep running.
Yeah, you don't want it on that there. Dead time.
Meanwhile, Augustin out of the 35 of Chanute. That was a huge penalty. Kaiser's got a lot of room. Gives that pump fake again across the line of scrimmage, but another flag goes down, and this one might be a hold.
But it stops the clock.
We'll get the call here. It is definitely a hold on Augusta. So Augusta gives it right back.
Yeah. Tackle on the by
Quentin Gregory. Quentin Gregory, another tackle. He's gotten his name called a couple times here. The senior, 6'2", 225-pound defensive lineman.
It's going to be a holding penalty charge, too. After he watches the
ref, they march them back, and it'll be first down again, but this time
20.
First down and 20.
Like after the first down, he just zooms.
I'm surprised they didn't put one back in the backfield.
Kaiser back to pass. Now it's a quarterback draw all the way from the beginning, and he's got room. Well, it has not been a bad call to let him run with the ball for tonight for Augusta. They call Kaiser's number again, and he's tall, he's rangy, he's got a long stride with those long legs, and he's powerful.
It's almost 8 to 10 yards every time he runs. He gets past the line.
So a gain of 9 on that quarterback draw brings up 2nd and 11. But we're going to go under 6 minutes to play here on this play. Kaiser back to pass. Boy, he has to avoid the rush and got drilled, but somehow got the ball out there to the right. Oh, my. He paid for it as he's doubled over a little bit, but what a throw. I don't know how he got that off, Coach.
I don't know how the receiver caught it.
Let's see how he did this. Does he shovel this ball? Oh boy, he just gets hammered, right? Well, this is the last play. That was the quarterback draw. So third down and six is the result. And yeah, definitely got two plays to get it. Trips to the near side. Kaiser back to pass. It's an option play. So he pitches it back to the right.
And the game two.
Defense stops him cold, maybe after a yard.
All depends. Oh, he didn't give him any. They didn't give him any.
We'll see who was there. Quentin Harding. Well, he's making himself known on the defensive end now after having just a whale of a night running the ball. He's been in on some important tackles here in the waning moments. Four and a half to go as the defense gets the crowd into it. This is the big play for Augusta if they want to have it keep any hope alive. Oh, it's a busted play. No, it's a fake and a good one. Okay, so Coach, explain to me what happened there.
They were going to try a Chanute was ready for a receiver screen to the wide side. Everybody bit. He side pitched it back to his running back out of the backfield.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. They faked a busted play there.
Right.
They faked it. The quarterback went to the left and looked around and did a fake pitch.
Yep. It looked like it was roll out to the right, going to go to the trips.
They've had some couple good trick plays tonight. Now this one's going nowhere. Quentin Harding again. Well, I suppose if you're going to have a night like he's had on offense, it just makes sense now that he's stepping up on defense. And boy, that play was going nowhere.
No.
Loss of about five. And the clock running here. And I don't know that Augusta's going to have the ability to keep huddling like that. They need to make a lot happen because they're running out of time. Kaiser has the snap, looking, lets one go. He's got a man, but overthrew it, and it's picked off. Caden Seamster. Well, he had him. He had him open. He just missed him. And that's the first real glaring mistake Kaiser's made tonight. He's played a pretty good game.
Yeah, he pushed that one.
So Seamster was the guy in the right place at the right time. He gets the interception, and that'll most likely do it.
A little strange of him to run out of bounds.
That could have been.
No sense. Save some time.
On that replay, Coach, and almost I wonder if the receiver, if he didn't go the way the quarterback thought he was going to go there. Yeah.
Right, yeah.
Because he looked frustrated, the receiver did, like he maybe wasn't in the right spot. That is
cut out instead of in.
We won't know.
No?
We won't know about that. They'll get that sorted out in the video room tomorrow, but that might not have been on Gavin. Chanute leads at 42-21 now with the ball. 3:19 to go in the game.
Freshman going in.
Kaysen Otis into the game. A freshman in a running back.
Quarterback.
Or no quarterback. So Kaysen Otis, a freshman quarterback in there. Chanute had to take a timeout. So we got some backups in there. We'll do our best to give you the names.
Good.
Number 24 out there, Logan Axelson. He's a sophomore wide receiver, 5'3".
Jalen Duncan, wide receiver, number 13. Don't look like 13.
Kaysen Otis, the freshman, is 5'8", 122. I haven't weighed that little since
Easton Claiborne.
I was 9. Probably why they never let me play quarterback.
We had to play football day.
72 out there, Steven Watson. We've got number 13, Jalen Duncan, as the running back to Kaysen Audis' quarterback. So the youngsters out there for the Blue Comets to end this game. Audis gives to Duncan. Duncan, boy, takes a shot after a gain of maybe one.
That was where Q would have just bounced it once, right past that guy, and then he's getting a touchdown. The freshman got the bounce and then got caught, though.
Second down and nine. So two freshmen out there, quarterback and running back. Number eight back in. Case and Audis back in with the play call. 15 on the play clock.
Gage Cummings, the sophomore, he's wide receiver.
I don't have a 16 on my roster if I was reading that number right. Here's a guy in motion, and is a give to the running back again. That's Jalen Duncan, who's fighting for some tough yards there. Number 19, also out there, Kemper Manley. He's a sophomore, 5'10", 142-pound wide receiver. It's always a fun time when these guys get out there. In the first game of the year, they didn't have to wait long to see the field in a varsity game.
Earn them quarters to a chance to get a letter.
It's important. It's important. You get a letter as a freshman or a sophomore. It's good stuff. Now, so they have to get so much time. It's not just you see the field in a varsity game, you don't get a letter automatically?
No.
Okay.
It's a certain amount of quarters.
Third down and seven upcoming. Here's the snap, the turn, and the give to Jalen. He's wrestled down after looks like no gain. Well, they got a shot, and they gained 3 yards on three plays. But they took time off the clock, which is what you wanted to do, and they didn't turn it over, and that's a win.
And they didn't lose any yards.
So
Seamster can give one a launch.
Back out to punt.
A spiral.
I'm assuming Augusta, if they have a punt rush play, they'll use it here.
You'd think so. 25-yard line down by...
They're not going to get this playoff, and they have to take a timeout. So we're under a minute to go, 46 seconds, and they just didn't get it in quick enough. And I had a late player on the field.
There's the check mark for tomorrow. Varsity team, special teams, always be ready.
Well, coach, overall, looking at a good week one here. Chanute is going to get out of here with a win.
Didn't, you know, the first half it seemed challenging. Chanute definitely put the third quarter away. He goes to Augusta wasn't lacking in strength or in the size of their players. Just definitely showed who is stronger in the weight room this summer and who put more endurance on the field over the last few weeks.
Yeah, this is an Augusta team that's going to win some football games, as we said earlier. This is not a bad football team.
Snap was good.
Boy, that's a high one, but really short. And it's going to hit and...
Kick short.
Augusta's going to get it on the Chanute half of the field. So looking to next week, Chanute doesn't get easier. They'll go to Pittsburgh next week, and now that will surely be a Pittsburgh team looking for some revenge.
From last year.
Pittsburgh usually is used to being on top in the SDK, and well, Chanute took it to them last year.
So shut out.
You're gonna see a Pittsburgh team that is highly motivated to defend their home turf against a team that worked him over pretty good last year. So that'll be a tough early season test for the young quarterback, Chris Harding II.
First and 10, Augusta, down the 22-yard line.
So Augusta has brought in their subs as well in the game. Number 7, Asher Philbeck, a freshman quarterback himself. He turns and gives, but we've got more penalties. And these officials don't want to go home, Coach.
They don't care that it's freshman.
No swallowing of the whistle here. Make that call. Throw that laundry.
It's their first game. They're getting prepared, Coach.
Well, I'll tell you what, here in the second half, you'd think they were getting paid by the whistle. not that they were close. I mean, there was all sorts of bad playing going on. All that nice talk we had in the first half of them not both teams looking pretty polished came crashing down in the second half. Boy, there is number 25, Jaden Harris, a freshman running back, and he just met a wall of blue. And that should do it. That should be the last play of the game, I'm guessing.
Yeah, they're going. He's going towards the sideline. Well, Chanute showed up and showed off at home.
Yeah, there were some hiccups there, but overall, you can't complain about a first week win over a game team in Augusta, senior-led team. So it was a tough first week opponent to test yourself against.
For us working together for 2 years, that's the first time we didn't have a ball go deep, though.
Yeah, he attempted the one, so he had Caden in the corner. But, yeah, you're right. There was no real deep passes, although it's hard to tell if they would have or wouldn't have done that if necessary, because Quentin Harding was running so well. And I think, like, we'll just save you the mystery. I'm assuming everyone's offensive game ball goes to junior running back Quentin Harding. He was fantastic for sure tonight. And boy, if you were wondering, well, what's this team going to do to replace touchdown Ty Leedy, who is such an amazing, amazing football player, and that's not even like he's better wrestler, which is amazing. I mean, just unbelievably talented kid. How are you going to replace that? Well, you got a definitive answer tonight, because Quentin Richardson is, I keep calling him Quentin Harding. Quentin Harding's the real deal.
He's on both sides of the real deal. He was bringing the wood on the defensive side, but his vision, like you said, he kept from getting hit.
Yeah.
He was floating.
It's very good. The line looked good tonight, as we assumed they would, as everyone assumed they would. Defensive side of the ball, who are you giving your defensive game ball to?
It's going to have to go to Smalls. It's going to have to go to Small. He was in on a lot of plays. He didn't let things get out on the outside of him.
Yeah. Cade, he's so solid out there. And the defensive side of the ball, boy, if they have the line play that looks like they're going to have, and the linebacker play that they got out of Landon Bilby,
I was going to say, I could take that back and go back to the first half.
Well, Landon Bilby just started off like lightning.
Yeah, he was on every play.
But still was all over the field seemingly in the second half, mm-hmm. although maybe they were running away from him a little bit, trying to neutralize him, but then you're dealing with Cade on the other side, and Quentin Richardson steps up and starts making some plays from the linebacker position. This is a stacked defense, and you might see going through this year a little bit of a different kind of strategy and style from this team, where maybe this isn't going to be a team that's so pass happy. I mean, you got a defense like that, maybe you're grinding games out, shortening it,
bringing it. They were in different defensive fronts. They ran a 5. They had a 5-2 out there a couple times. They had a 3-man front.
Yeah.
Last year we stayed in the 4-3 no matter what.
Yeah. Overall, it's a great first week. And we'll move on to Pittsburgh next week. Big, doesn't let up. Big second game right off the bat. Chanute wins it 42-21 on behalf of Mr. Caleb Wood, the instructor for the television broadcasting classes here. Everything you saw on your stream tonight, brought to you by high school students. They're doing all the work. They're doing the producing. The graphics is good stuff. And on behalf of them, on behalf of the coach, Chad Graham, my name is Dave. We'll see you next time.
Good night.